Boy, that escalated quickly. I mean, that really got out of hand fast.
Good evening. Good afternoon. Good morning. Can you hear me now? Whatever the case may be. It's a Friday night work stream. I'm going to be... This is just a layout piece. I had to open it up because I want to do a double page spread layout. So that's what I have on screen. I'm going to be redoing my cover for Monster Hunt 2 because Matthew Weldon is an evil genius, and I can't hand in what I handed in for my cover when Weldon is turning in this double page monstrosity because I'm a competitive jerk. But all the better for you guys who are going to be backing this book, that you get a better cover than the one I can produce, or the one that I did produce. So I'm going to do something a little more schmancy and a little more fancy in the schmancy, if you know what I'm saying. So, hey, do me a favor. Like and share. Oh, wait, not create post. That's not what I wanted. Share to tweeters. I didn't really plan on a bullpen, so I didn't send out question inquiries earlier. So I kind of just dropped the link to a couple of people. I really need to get back on having like a big room full of people who might want to come in and just hang out. But I know it's mostly on my channel. It's just been artists, right? Just artists almost completely and almost all the time. Just artists, which, you know, it's cool. I'm okay with it. But, you know, the way I used to do it, I just had a big, what did I call that? It was just like the Blacklist Universe Green Room. Ah, that's what it was. The Blacklist Universe Green Room. And I just had, everybody was in there and I would just drop the link and whoever would come in would come in. But I noped out of that room and I don't think I ever got back in. So where is Weldon? This is the question. Please, Jiminy, let's find Weldon. Matt, if you're watching,
yeah,
just come in. I know you don't get as much work done, but you can get some work done. Let's switch this out so that it's not me all big. It's me, little bitty guy here over here in the corner, right? It's little old me. And I can delete this. Where's my pages? All right, let's see here. Oops, tab. Oh, that's what I needed, the tab. All right. And then what happened here? I thought I merged all these.
Yeah.
And then all delete. And then save this off separately as a Lone Star Monster Hunt 2. Mike. This is just going to cost me more money because now I have to pay for colors to do a double page cover. I have to. Okay. And then deselect. All right. So here's the cover. What was I going to do?
Nothing.
I want to do something. Oops. I don't want a clone stamp. I want a brush. Just give me a brush, darn it. Let's see if I'm looking this far out. Well, I don't want to do that. That's the problem, is now I have to think through this. Jiminy, you want to come in? Jiminy Cricket, you want to join? Jiminy Cricket in my soup. Lions and tigers pooping poop. Is that how it goes? I don't think that's how it goes. Oh, shoot. I forgot. I have to have Mike Barron on by the end of the month to help with his book. I don't know how much help being on my stream is, but I sent one to Elliot. I haven't even sent one to Elliot. I don't know if Elliot, I don't have my phone, and like, I don't know if Elliot even checks his messenger. My wife is using my phone. Don't tell anybody. Richard Friend. He doesn't stream late, though. Walden. I could drop him a line. Boop. Walden Wong. Bring us Mike Barron. Jiminy. Bring us Jiminy. Jiminy. It is. I like being a more artist-centered stream, though. That it's good, right? It's good. It's good to have other people here too. But I think it's good to have more art-centered stream. You know, I wonder if Ben ever want to come on. Cosin, I don't know what happened to Cosin. Cosin just disappears. There's Kenneth Rocafort. He's not on right now, though. I don't know. We want Jiminy. Jiminy. We want Jiminy. We want Jiminy. 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 Sorry, I should have done the layout before I got on stream. Because I need to, like, focus to do layouts. I'm not like Weldon where I just... I don't even think, and stuff just comes out of my hands. But trying to see the problem with doing a cover like this is that your action wants to be on this page. Whoops. Your action wants to be on this page. Your title is here. Right? And then your action, if you're doing a double page spread, your action is here. Ooh, what the heck? Why am I getting lag? Hold on, I gotta close some stuff out here.
Okay, now I'm
close that, close that. Close that. We're getting up pretty high. Doing pretty good on the mailing list. Oh, shoot. I should have put the mailing list in the... LoneStarComic.com if you guys haven't signed up to the mailing list. But also... I'm looking at Shadow of the Conqueror doing quite well as far as signups. And I just want to close everything because I am really chugging up my machine right now, I think. Oh, I've got another whole set of windows open. That's why. All right, let's see. Close that. Close that. Close that. All right. Now let's see. It's still lagging. What the front door? All right, let me come over here, close this. Sorry, that means I can't watch. Close Twitter. Is anything else even open? What's up, Jiminy?
Hey, how you doing? Can you hear me?
Doing all right. I'm just trying to maximize my speed on my thing here. That's still a tiny bit of lag, darn it.
Huh.
All right, so anyways, how you doing, bro?
Doing pretty well, thanks. I'm trying to do some Inktober artwork, but I'm really bad at it. So,
Gary, I sent you the link.
I'm bad at keeping up with it every day, so I figured I'll just do whatever I want and not worry about actually doing 31 drawings.
There you go. That's how you do. So, I was trying to make the point that if you're doing you know, a double page cover, it's like you've got your, you want your action, you want your focus and stuff to be here, right?
Right.
The problem with that being that the rest of the action is going the wrong way on the second, on the back cover. Right?
Yeah.
You don't want your action going this way, generally speaking. At least not in storytelling.
Right, but you... I mean, the best ones I've seen have been where the action starts on the back page, and then it moves towards the front. So when you're looking at the front cover, that's where, you know, that's the foreground, and then that's the background.
That's an interesting way to go.
So it's moving from left to right, and then you're catching the tail end, like right when, boom, you know, Wolverine's about to snick you or whatever.
I may pack.
Right. I want to do something sort of, or you could do something like curvilinear.
Right. Yes.
Like that. Like I'm going to pack him in Jim G, this mother. Do a straight up crazy curvilinear perspective.
So who is the focus going to be on this cover for you? Is it going to be Nexus or which character?
I was going to focus on Lone Star.
Oh, that's a good choice. Cool.
Well, you know, he is the... Oops.
Like... And you've gotten the story already from Mike Baron?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So anything you can tell us in terms of hints?
Hints about what? I don't know what you mean, Jimmy.
Like, what
Nexus part is in it?
What part does Nexus play in a story?
Can
you say or no?
A hero.
Okay. He's a hero. Okay. I mean, I want to know, but I kind of don't want to know. I don't want you to ruin it. So,
interestingly enough, his role has changed from my initial pitch to Mike to what it ultimately ended up being.
Right. Okay. Yeah, because I can kind of guess what Lone Star's role in the thing is. I mean, I'm guessing that he hears a Bigfoot Bill, some sort of monster, and he goes out to stop him with the Unknown Soldiers.
See, that was my initial pitch.
Oh, really?
And boy, Mike just really turned this whole thing on its head.
Oh, wow. Okay. Cool. I'm looking forward to seeing it. So,
Roscoe says, hi, crew. Mike, what was the members only stream? I woke up to find it not there. Just curious. Well, sorry. You weren't awake for it. You weren't awake for it. And now I deleted it. So, oh, well. It is what it is, my friend. What should I do here?
So, what didn't you like about your original cover?
The cover.
So you're willing to give that away?
I did it on Drawn and Quartered, and then I just kind of finished it afterwards. And it just really feels rushed.
Okay.
So.
No, I understand.
Yeah. I want to do something kind of epic.
Yeah. And Matthew Weldon's doing the interior art?
He is. Wow. And it's wonderful. I've got 5 pages so far.
And how long is this book going to be?
48 pages.
Yes. Good.
Yeah. It's going to be its own campaign.
Okay, cool. Very good. Because that was my main, I guess, complaint about the first one. It was too short.
That was my complaint as well.
Yeah. I thought I had too much story for too short of a 22-page
comic. I absolutely agree. I was unfortunately bound by agreement with someone who forgot about the agreement. So I legit could have just made that a 48-pager
and
made it its own campaign.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I would have been much better served. I would have sold. It would have been...
That's okay. Don't worry about it. Live and learn.
Well, then I was given grief. yeah. for making that decision. That wasn't my decision by the person who made the decision. I'm like, you got to be kidding me at this point. That's right, Comics Bear. It should have been its own campaign. Yeah. It absolutely should have been.
Yep. But I think it's very cool that you're taking that, that just that concept of Monster Hunt and making it into sort of like a mini series. I think that's a great idea.
Sort of a series.
Yeah.
Well, it's more along the lines of what did they, you know, Marvel team up.
Right. Yeah.
Let's see, Gormando.
It's like Marvel 3-in-1. Starring Lone Star.
Yeah. Blacklist 3-in-1. I could change Monster Hunt to Blacklist 3-in-1.
Very cool.
Gormando Steve Wood. I need a freaking. I need a reference for this character.
Trying to get the water. Get him. I did like. He's got a lot of HP. Don't go near him, son.
Dang it. Right. I know Weldon has a reference. Weldon, if you're watching, would you wake up?
He's in a peanut butter coma.
I need help. I need reference. Oh, he just posted something an hour ago on Facebook.
I saw it on Twitter a little while ago.
Oh, you know what? I'm just going to call him.
Uh-oh. Oh no, he's doing it live.
I'm doing it live.
That does 9 damage.
How much damage did you do? He's hiding. He ran to the bathroom.
Yeah, he's watching you call him right now.
He's tracking me down.
I know you're there. Matthew.
His face is covered with peanut butter. He's trying desperately to lick it off.
Well then. Answer the phone.
Is Cawson coming in? I don't know. I'm just going to let this ring like all night long. He's like covering his computer. The speakers are like, it's on his phone and it's on his computer, right? Because it's Facebook. So it's like ringing all over the house. No. Mr. Dead in his pocket. Hello. Oh, no answer, huh, Matt?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
He's hiding.
Really?
He's hiding.
All right, let's try Elliot. Elliot.
Oh, no.
Mr. Dead in his pocket is here.
Elliot, come out and play. Elliot, come out and play.
Give me a minute. I'll be right there.
All right.
Poor Elliot, man. He's like, man, I just went to bed.
I know, right?
It's like, I'm 3 hours ahead of you, Mike.
I know. But he stays up so late. That guy. Where in the... Oh, hold on. I'm not sure. Let me see if he put the reference in this chat. This chat. Which I could share, and you could see the first 5 pages of Monster Hunt and Lone Star. Mm. What do you think? Should I do that?
What do you want to do?
You want to see the first 5 pages?
Yeah.
All right, I got to stop the screen then and share
it. Let's see it.
I got to share my third screen here.
Ooh,
all right, let's start with page 1.
Yeah.
East page 1.
Wow.
So what's the Lone Star Monster Hunt 2 crossover with Lone Star and Nexus? This is Nighthawk
Wow. Man.
Can you resize your logo image? I can't see that person who's with you's name. It's just Jason. You don't need to see his name.
It's just Jiminy Cricket. Don't worry about it. I'm nobody. I don't.
They must know your name, sir. They must know your name. Here, let me just move it over there. Isn't that nice? Take my money, Mike. I know, right?
Seriously. Matthew Weldon's art will sell me on pretty much any book.
I know. How every book he does doesn't do freaking $50,000 is beyond me.
Yeah.
It's...
I think it's just because people don't know about him. I mean, there's just a lack of...
I don't know. Drives me crazy.
Drives me crazy. Like no one else.
You see? Are you looking at this other page? I got 5 pages here.
Beautiful work. It is insane. I love his layouts.
Yeah.
Dang.
Of course, now I feel like I'm in a competition with him, so I have to.
I mean, guys like him and Kanan White, I look at their artwork, and it just makes me want to improve my art.
Ooh, Andrew Hayes says, I don't like the large blacks in Weldon's inks.
What?
I like
Andrew. What? What?
I don't spot blacks.
What? Spotting black, I mean.
I've gotten him used to, not having to spot blacks.
So. Matthew Weldon has it right. He spots blacks when they need to be spotted, and he crosshatches.
Yeah. Your opinion is duly noted, Jason.
Good. It should be.
Noted and shelved.
Learn from Weldon, Matt. Mike. Oh, wow. Ouch. What the? Oh, man. He's even drawing motorcycles good.
Uh-huh.
What? Now, why did he punch that guy? I'm trying to figure it out.
Because he's a Hala Akbar.
Okay. Got it. Nice. Nice,
how
nice.
Do you draw a black and white cookie? Is that a joke? What? Okay, what's the punchline? How do you draw a black and white cookie? With chocolate chips? I don't know. I have no idea.
Nice. All right. What is he? He's sitting down? What is he doing?
He's pulling his... He's sneaking up on the guy.
He's... What? It looks like he's sitting down taking a break.
Do you see the windows in the first?
This is so cool.
In the first panel?
Yeah.
Do you see how that window ledge is about the height of the thing above his head?
Oh boy. Okay. That's a little confusing. But, okay. Got it. Wait. Did he just kill a guy?
Yeah.
A throwing star?
Uh-huh.
What?
Right. Wow, have fun at work.
Dang, right in the forehead. Ouch.
Yes, because he's a bad guy. He's a terrorist. Oh. Terrorists
Man. Get
to die.
Dang. And this is written by Mike Barron.
Yeah.
Man. He's hardcore.
Yeah, good stuff. Good stuff. So, yeah, that's the 5 pages we got so far.
Nice.
But I'm looking for a Gourmando. This is... Oh, here's this double-page spread cover that irritates me, and now I have to do better.
Wow, yeah.
Were they all plushies?
No, I understand. You gotta do better, Mike.
Right?
Be better. Be better, Mike.
Right?
Hashtag be better.
Right? How annoying. How freaking annoying is it now that I have to compete with that?
Yeah. And he did that in like an hour with a G2 pen.
Shut up.
That's why I have like
shut
a
up,
love
Jason.
Oh my God.
That's why I have a love hate thing with Matt Weldon. I love his art, but I hate his art because he's so good and he's so fast.
Yes, it's very annoying. Yeah, Elijah left. I think I'm going to do this. as far as
I really want to see what you have in mind.
Maybe even this. Yeah, that'd be good. All right.
I'm just trying to shape perspective here. Yeah, I like that angle.
So what I want to do, if I can get the bloody reference, is do like, because Gormando is like this giant, you know, Galactus type. So I'm going to have him here and have his hand stretching out here.
Like this.
Oh, my guy went out.
Nice.
And then
Kirby-esque.
Well, yeah, it's a Kirby monster, you know.
Cool.
Well, Kirby type monster.
Right. Nice, I like that. That's good.
Like that, and then have all the other characters because they're so much smaller than he is. I can just play them out.
Yeah.
Ooh, I can actually change the.
Look how big this guy is, Isaac.
Now what about the title?
Shut up.
You gotta leave space for the title, Mike.
Cool. Something like that.
Oh, nice.
But I need reference for this beast. And Weldon has it.
Now, is this a character that Weldon designed himself?
No, Steve Rude.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Steve, and the next Nexus series is called Gormando.
Oh, okay.
Rad, because Mike decided to make that the main villain for this.
Okay. You can't find it online?
I know I've seen it. That's what's driving me nuts. I don't remember where it was. So now I have to dig around. Jalapeno milk. You wanna have jalapeno milk in here? every time I stop and do something, you know, it takes me time. All right, invite Cape. Let me get my Twitter open again.
If you find the hole, you go down there. It'll lead you to the crystal
thing,
and you go up.
All right. Where is he? Where is the jalapeno? There he is.
It's like a huge crimson.
Nice. Timothy says, I'm full of fast food. So the front cover is a hand. No, that is the background. The background is a hand. What book is Gormando going to be in? Nexus Gormando. It's the next series from Steve Rude and Mike Barron. And then Mike Barron just wrote a novel with Gormando in it.
Oh, okay.
All right, so he's also got his little Silver Surfer dude, Gnosis.
And a Silver Surfer character? Too?
Yeah, he's got a Silver Surfer character, so I'm gonna put him.
You go on the side of the
like here. I'm just getting more surfing, dude.
Okay, where are you?
Waves are life. Surfing is life, right? There. It's a good spot for it.
Hey, Mecca, how you doing?
Hey, what's up, Mecca?
Hey, I thought I'd just sneak in here.
You have snuck.
Jason, how are you?
Doing well, thank you very much. Hope you're doing good, too.
I think I am. I got in an argument with my cat, but
I'm not
sure. He wouldn't come inside.
Cat argument, eh?
Yeah, he wouldn't come inside, so I chased him until I got sweaty, and then I had to take a shower. He's inside and down, though. What are you working on, Mike?
I'm redoing the cover.
Redoing?
Oh, there's the Gourmand. Okay, here's the... You guys want to see the reference? No. I don't want to drag it from page to page. Never mind. I think he's only got three fingers. A lookalocky only got three fingers. Darn it. I hate
only three fingers for the Michael Caine.
I don't like the three fingers thing.
So Mr. Caine.
Because I'd have to delete these fingers here.
Wait, can you...
I would delete this one, not that one.
Ooh. Would you say fingers were sausages?
Sausages, sure.
Snossages?
Snossages.
Snossages.
Debbie, would you like some sausage? Would you like some sausage? For your sausage. So what's going on in the wild, wild world of sports?
What in the... Not much on my end of things.
No? Nothing new in the...
What in the wide, wide world of sports is going on here?
Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain.
I just started reading XO Manowar.
Yeah?
How is that?
The original or the new one?
I was actually going to ask you because... I don't know. It looks really new artwork, and I'm really enjoying it. But I think this is the 2012 version, but it's really good. So, And I swear the XO Manowar thing was like 90s, wasn't it?
Yeah, yeah, that was Valiant. Was it Valiant?
Valiant. Yeah. And all that Ninjak.
Right. Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah. This new one I'm reading seems to have Ninjak in it, and the art's really fine. The artist is Let me see if I can find it. What's this guy's name? Venditti, Garbett, and Guadiano.
Not familiar with them.
Yeah, and Moose Bauman on colors.
This sounds foreign.
Yeah, 2012. I guess it was a newer one.
Okay.
It's really enjoyable, though.
Yeah.
Sounds like one of them foreigners.
Is he still fighting like those spider aliens or?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, those things. The vine, I think they call them. Yeah. Yeah. It seems like people are pretty. Oh, look who's here!
Who's here?
The jiggy jiggy, the jiggy jiggy jiggy. Mm-hmm. All right, I'm bumping you to the bottom, Mecca, so that we cool. can.
You can do that.
I was scratching the record.
What's up, y'all?
Hey.
Hello.
Elliot came out to play.
That was so creepy. My wife was like, "What is going on there?" I said, "Don't worry, it's just Mike."
He was doing that for like 5 minutes before you got in.
I was trying to call Weldon first.
Come out to play, Weldon.
Mecca is not Zippy, I promise.
All right, I need another layer. So, Elliot, I've been thoroughly shamed by my Monster Hunt cover, and now I am redoing mine.
You want me to do another one? You said?
No. I was shamed. You and Matthew shamed me.
I don't think that's true, Michael. No, I think yours is wonderful. You know what? I do have to draw the big guy, Gourmonger. I still have to do the little thing, or do you want to just keep the same one as the last one?
Oh, you mean the little one? Yeah. Oh, you mean keep the same Lone Star face? Oh, that's not a bad idea.
Yeah, that way you're branding it better. You know, more.
Yeah,
branding.
Yeah.
All right, then we'll do that then.
Okay.
Just watch those.
Mike's face is cut off on the screen now. Nobody needs to see my face. They can see my.
You can see my bottom lip.
Just duck down like this, like you did on my live stream on Instagram. People are like, who's the forehead? It's just Mike. So, Mike, I want you to know you're episode one in Jerkmonger.
Jerkmong. Freezy freeze.
He's froze.
He's frozen.
Oh no.
Oh, he's back.
Did I?
Yes, he's back.
Oh. He's back. I might have computer trouble tonight. But anyway, yeah, you're episode one in Jerkmonger team ups.
Nice.
That's fun.
I'm calling that. I need a little cool.
Is that an Instagram exclusive?
It is right now because it's in that format, which is good for me because it fits in my schedule better right now. Mm. I'm not trying to compete with Brian Shearer's production values or Mike Miller's meme controls.
Ramsey's number one.
Oh, something of desire.
Ba 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 dee.
Is number one of the secrets of desire.
I don't think they did end Paranormals. Just guys are busy.
Yeah, there's been a lot of stuff going on. Life is happening, and also with the addition of certain elements in the show, it's made it much more complicated to produce. So when he was busy and I was busy, there was some problems.
For so long. What did you get? It's a quick.
So what I'm going to do, I'm going to keep doing the team ups with other people that I know on throughout Instagram and such, and throughout the comic world.
Nice.
And do little hangout. Just I'm going to try to keep it shorter. And you know, as long as I have a project to do, and so you're going to come back a few more times here and there. You're going to be a regular guest of mine. And nice. It's going to be fun. That way you can keep promoting projects on Instagram that way. Because cool. In the description for the series, it says hanging out with some of my favorite friends and artists, talking shop, and shameless product placement. So it's just a commercial. That's all it is.
Cool.
All right. I need to look at. I need to see my stuff.
Are you drawing the Silver Surfer, Mike?
No, that is Gnosis.
That's looking great already, Mike.
Much better.
Gnosis negative.
Crap I drew before. Huh?
So the only thing we need heads for if we're gonna do it is the box in the top left corner. I say we've got Lone Star. Let's just grab a Bigfoot Bill. Let's do like the way they did in the old Marvel comics. Just grab something from other places, put it in there.
Oh, I see. So you don't want to do the drawing.
Okay, Michael, I'll just draw it for you. No problem.
I'm just wondering.
I'm gonna do it right now. Don't worry about it. I'm just saying.
Hey, whatever you want to do is good. You know, whatever.
Listen, I'm just saying. I was trying to make it look more authentic.
I'm just saying.
I always thought it was cool when you saw a little bit of a Paul Smith's Wolverine or something, and John Byrne's, you know, somebody else, and it was like, oh, it's like a collage.
Yeah, but I thought John Byrne always did his own.
Maybe. I don't remember. I'm just saying in general, that's how I remember it.
John Byrne.
You have the Quetzal?
So I have a child that my wife has taught in the past. And he's kind of a special needs kid, sweet kid. And he's 8 now and he loves Wolverine.
Ah.
So I gave him my Marvel Legends brown suit Wolverine.
Ah.
And Andy brought over it's a Daredevil issue with brown suited Wolverine in it. And I'm excited. It's going to be fun to give it to him.
Wait, it's a book or a
figure?
A figure, yeah.
An action figure. Because he likes Wolverine. He's 8 years old, man. And I gave him a comic, and I gave him more Avengers toys too. I'm trying to get rid of my stuff. I want to start traveling a little lighter.
I'll send my ad.
What I say?
Stuff.
What? What, Jiminy?
I said I'll give Elliot my address. He can send me all this stuff that he doesn't want.
Well, that's
he didn't want to give him to some thankless child.
And I live in Florida, so I can just drive over and pick it up.
That's true. But are you a special needs child? I don't think so.
Ask my mom. She will tell you yes.
Well, my mom said the same thing about me. That's why I have all this stuff.
I have many people that would vouch for that.
Where are you at? Where? What? Are you close to me?
No, my sister's close to you. I'm on the East Coast.
Oh.
I'm just north of Boca Raton.
Let's make that work, man. Are you ever on this side of town?
Every once in a while when I visit my sister, but
well, bro, dude, I'm right here, dog. Come on.
Okay.
Come
well, next time I'm over there, I will contact you and let you know.
Yeah, dude. That'd be fantastic.
You'll regret ever making the offer.
Well, I didn't say you can live in my house. I'm just saying.
That guy Jiminy just won't leave. He keeps on asking me questions.
Well, with a name like Jiminy, he's welcome.
Okay, cool. I'll let you know next time I'm on the West Coast.
We'll do a live. We'll live stream with Mike together.
East Coast, West Coast confusion.
We have our own East Coast and West Coast.
You don't understand. We're talking about Florida here.
I know. Yeah,
like just
the important West Coast.
Yeah, we're cool.
That's sort of a non sequitur. Mr. Dead in His Pocket just says, "But I hate my sister."
No.
Is that you, Jiminy?
No. I mean, not really.
You know, once in a while.
Yeah, once in a while she gets on my nerves, but
you know what the hard layout is? Doing something that's iconic at the same time as trying to do something new.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's tricky.
Seen this pose 4,000 times before.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But it's not really inspiring me.
I mean, I've seen a pose that has been done 1,000 times before, but just someone can just make it work, you know? So give it a shot. It looks good.
I hate it.
Okay.
I think it does look good. I think you're overthinking.
I am overthinking it. Yeah, I got a problem with that.
Yeah.
Is that like a front and back cover?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, is that what it takes for Mike Miller? He's got to go on both sides of the cover. Poor Mike.
Yeah, it's freaking Weldon. What a jerk. Does a double stinking spread cover. Makes me look like a chump with my single spread nothing.
I have this interesting idea, Mike.
Oh, good. Tell me.
One of these times, we should do a cover where we all do some of it.
Oh, a jam cover.
A jam cover, and then somebody inks it. One of us inks it, or some of us can ink parts of it.
Jam.
I can ink it.
That'd be kind of cool. I don't. Have you ever inked my work, Mike?
No.
That'd be kind of. I don't know if that's inkable.
I would love to see Mike ink your pencils.
Do that on the next Drawn and Quartered.
I think that'd be fantastic.
I absolutely could do that.
Well, I'm saying it'd be a good, an interesting thing to do with a team of artists instead. Remember we had that conversation about maybe doing something drawn and quartered even where we would.
Yeah.
It's more complicated, but that might be the kind of thing we could do. Or it could just be something you can do for a show.
Yeah.
You could even do it right now.
I'm busy. People are trying to take up my time.
Like you bust out a whole book in like 4 months. It would be like peanuts to you.
Actually. Yeah, really?
Oh, five.
Yeah. Well, I went back to the earliest pages. I'm like, that was 5 months. How?
Excuse me.
Excuse me for the support.
Don't you support me, mister.
I know. Should go hang out on that other channel they're doing auctions on. Yuck.
Oh, is there something going on tonight?
Yeah, there's an auction over on Frog's.
Is that don't use words.
I wish them all the greatest success.
So do I.
Kelsey sold a piece for $1,900. Pretty stoked.
What? That?
Yeah, Kelsey.
Wow.
Right.
I love Frog's now.
I like Kelsey. I love Kelsey very much.
Kelsey is awesome.
I don't think Kelsey loves me very much anymore, but that's okay.
Oh, stop it.
I can't get a hold of that guy.
Everyone loves Elliot.
No, that's not true. But that's okay. I'm embracing the monger, my monger side more than ever. I'm the monger you love to hate. That's how I like it.
You know, I didn't realize these guys both have visors. I could have done something design, not back fully.
I keep thinking you're drawing like a castle in the sky or something with that big thing in the middle of the forehead, like an automaton or something.
Oh, sorry.
A ribbon in
the sky. Oh, it's me that critically.
A ribbon in the sky.
I mean, I think it looks good.
They're making fun of me in chat. Oh, look at Pencil for Live. Brad and I had a great conversation today. I love that guy.
Oh, yeah? Why isn't he in here?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Why are people on my show? Why is everyone scared?
They've seen your review stream. So.
My review show.
It's not Saturday, guys. The water's fine.
You're relatively safe.
Bite your head off.
I got a lambasting from Mecca. He said I was cruel, insensitive. He said, I have some new rules. If I continue to be involved in this charade,
some demands, if you will.
Yeah, I'm gonna have.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's my house.
It's my dictatorship.
That's why I'm telling you first what I'm gonna do.
What is happening? Is this some sort of a coup d'etat?
It's a mutiny.
It's an intervention.
It's an intervention. That's right.
I'm trying to intervene on behalf of art.
Is that what they call that?
So that
we don't
craft art created.
I'm just saying, I'm going to start asking questions like,
how old are you?
What is the context of this? What are you trying to achieve? That is approachable. Because if they're
trying, the way Dave Finch does his critique.
Did I say that loud enough?
You know, the way Dave Finch does it is he brings the artists onto the stream and he does all his critique to their face.
Oh, that's great. Why don't you go watch Dave Finch's show?
He only does it once a month. That's why.
Oh, man.
I'm just saying, if you really wanted to be hardcore, invite the artists on the stream.
We'll make them cry on camera. That'd be awesome.
That's right.
I'm trying to be objective, which means I don't want to look at some sad puppy dog and be like, oh, I don't want to hurt this guy's feelings.
But Mike, why don't you like my artwork? I'm only 12.
I don't care.
Well, let me explain it to you, kid.
Mecca said I turned somebody's 8-year-old into mush. And their inner 8-year-old, he said I was mean.
Jerkmonger ran him over, man. And he backed up.
Wow. Wow. I didn't. It's not what I was trying to do.
He farted and said, "Oh, that one's gonna itch."
I gotta get a screenshot of this movie I saw, and I'm gonna send you guys who I think it looks like, and you're gonna change your mind about the monger. Very fast. Well, I don't want to say because it's going to be so. You think I'm mean now? Oh my goodness! Hey, I'm going to
put my camera. Gary and Elliot are too nice, and no one takes Mike seriously. Wow, Jeff Potts.
Wait, what?
Jeff Potts here. Look at this.
No one takes me seriously.
They take his critique pretty seriously, judging by the hurt feeling.
Yeah.
Jeez. Well, it's for the kids. What are you gonna do?
Because people come out of the show thinking, "Oh, Mike's gonna ask me to draw the next Monster Hunt cover."
No,
that's my job. Hello. No, I'm just kidding. Let me see here. I'm gonna position my Camaro.
You're 1968,
dude. I would not mind. Nice Camaro. But I don't have the money for that nonsense. What's wrong with you, boy? All right.
Boy, you lose your mind because I help you find it.
I'm kind of warming up here. I've been working on my commission. I'm working on a Cowboy Bebop commission.
Oh.
Did you see it? Did you see it yet, Jiminy?
No. I haven't.
So far?
See.
Here, I'll show you. See. I will show you, my friend.
See, why risk having your artwork critiqued when you could just pay somebody else to do it?
See that, Jimmy? You see that? Cool. I started it.
Nice.
So this is jet black.
Blue.
Is that a digital commission?
No, no. I'm doing some layouts right now.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to lighten it up and do some pencil. Oh, like
look at this freaking garbage. People just come here to piss me off. That's like why they come to my show. Like,
you get an oxygen.
Hey, let's see what I can say to Mike. See if he wants to flip his table over.
That's what I did for like a year on your channel.
Mike is rash. Trash.
What the heck? No, that's not what I meant.
Dang.
I'm sorry. I don't know well. I meant to say rad.
Yeah, that was spell check.
Were you playing Battletoads or something?
Look, Mike, it says it now. Look, in the corner there. You can see on the little square. Mike is rad. See?
That was the automatic correct.
I feel like that's
correct. So.
Well, it's also in separate layers. So look what happens, Mike. Look what happens. Disappears. No more.
Dishonesty from this crowd.
Palpable.
Oh, man.
Now, how do I make this Bigfoot?
Where's that foot coming from?
What foot?
That foot you put next to that guy's knees.
Foot next to knees?
Yeah, coming out of that diving man's knees. Was that a foot you said?
Diving man.
Yeah, the diving man in the palm of the big guy's hand.
Nexus.
Yeah, you just put a foot on his knee?
No, I'm drawing Bigfoot Bill.
Oh, you started him on his kneecaps?
The hell are you talking about?
Bigfoot Bill's head.
Oh, that's Bigfoot Bill.
Mecca! Shut up!
Well, you said something about a foot, and I'm looking, and I'm like, why is it coming out of the guy's kneecap?
Kneecaps.
Yeah, I know I'm the least experienced with art here, but
that's okay. Don't worry about it.
I might be the least experienced.
Need a normie's point of view.
Yeah, but I'm probably having the most fun with my art.
Yeah, we need a muggle in the chat so that Mike can understand that. Yes, he has to make the art legible for normal people.
That's right.
Readable.
Did you just call him a muggle?
Muggle. Yeah.
That's so wrong, man.
Yeah.
Why? It's a racist.
Shut up.
Well, it kind of is.
Awesome.
Now you can't come to my home. Anyway. Just kidding. Just kidding. Man, come on. I play. I'm the jerk monger. It's okay.
You are a jerk.
I know. I love it. I'm the monger you love to hate, baby.
Baby, don't you cry.
What?
I don't
Let's
want
to see.
Big flopping feet.
Wait.
Somebody's noticing you're drawing a nice set of melons there.
It's just the underdrawing for the rest of the costume. Relax, y'all. I'm just trying to do something unique. That's all. Trying.
Melanie.
Sure.
Shorty's like a Melanie.
This is just a warm up for me. This is a warm up. I need to do some more angels for my art book too. I haven't done that in a while.
You got another sketchbook coming out?
Not yet. I have a couple of things in the hopper. I'm just I'm literally trying to get this. I'm feverishly trying to finish up a few loose ends here so I can go hard back onto Doom Kicker schedule. So right now, but I figure if I'm going to draw anything, it should be something towards what I want to do later on. So I still have a concept I'm putting together for the Valkyries and Angels. Andy's helping me go through some of my artwork that I've already done in the past.
Right.
So I can't find other elements that I can incorporate. So we'll see. Because I need to. Did you know Brian launched? He wrapped up his Kickstarter yesterday, and right away launched his new volume 2 Brian Shearer Volume 2 art book. The art of Gunship? Yeah, on Indiegogo. So you guys should check it out.
Gunship 2's up already?
No, Art of Brian Shearer Volume
2. Oh, sketchbook.
Art book out. Speaking of art books.
Oh, okay.
I feel like that's too far open.
Yeah. He just got funded on the Kickstarter for Gunship Thunder Punch.
Here for a few more.
Yeah.
He sold a few more of those. I'm happy for him. Super proud. He was my episode 2. That's what gave me the idea. I said, well, Brian came on. Mike was on. Uh-oh. This is turning into a thing. Because I can't do the cigars anymore. On Instagram. I was trying to do like a cigar review.
Cool.
But now
allow that on Instagram, huh?
But now I do have the disease I was worried about. So,
what the heck was that?
All I can do now is drink alcohol.
Nice.
That's all I got left.
That's all I've ever done.
I can't have
all nicotine. I've ever needed.
I can't have nicotine. I can't have caffeine. I haven't drank coffee in a couple weeks.
Oh, that hurts.
Yes, it did. It hurt. I had a headache for a while.
Oh, how was your doctor's appointment?
Oh yeah. I have Meniere's. Brian calls it Meniere's disease.
Meniere?
So, yeah, I have Meniere's disease. No, I have a Meniere's disease. It's
it's not Monet.
No, I thought it was Meniere too. I thought that's how you pronounced it. But some kind of it's been affecting me for about a year now. I just didn't know. It's just getting more severe now. And I get the vertigo from, my equilibrium is off because I'm retaining water in my ear, where it's supposed to be draining through your normal sinus tract. Mine's getting stuck.
Mm.
At first, the doctor thought I might have a tumor. I said, what the hell are you talking about? Excuse me. He goes, oh, no, the last guy had it. So maybe you might have it. I said, what? He goes, don't worry, it wouldn't be cancer. He says, well, then you should leak with that. That was,
yeah.
But I have like very bad hearing in the right ear. It's causing vertigo and nausea and
okay
other things. And
wow,
I'm old. So there you go.
Hey, you're not old until you're older than me.
Or isn't there somebody else older? Gary Shipman's younger than us, right?
I am. I'm older.
I am.
Oh, really? Well, there you go.
Old. I'm older.
No, you're old.
Really?
Wow. Dude, you're emotional today.
I am.
I'm old.
Gosh, man.
I'm going through menopause. I'm old.
Old people are old.
I hear that.
Menopause.
Man-o-pause.
Man-o-pause.
P-Money says, we'll chat louder, jerkmonger. That's funny. That's funny.
Kind of me. Funny.
So, yeah, I got my daughter's like, Dad, I'm tired of repeating myself. So I said, look, child. I have these nightmares of me with those. Remember those old horns they used to put in their ear?
Oh, right. Yeah.
What'd you say, Sonny? What'd you say?
What'd you say?
Who is this character? Let me see. Who can I ask here? Mecca, who's this character going to be?
The one you're drawing?
Yeah.
It's an original you're drawing right now?
Yeah.
Well, I like Melanie.
That's not a person. That's just a loose title.
Melody? This kind of has like Angelina Jolie to it with the jawbones all up high and stuff.
Who?
Angelina Jolie kind of has that older, distinguished look.
You can call her Viagra.
Whoa. I'm trying to make her a character so I can give her a costume and then call it a day.
What's her power set?
I don't know. I mean, like, is she Jean Grey? Is she? I'm looking for things, something like that.
No, you're looking for an action. You're not making a character.
I'm just gonna. This is a warm up. I'm just trying to
get. Feels like a storm or something.
No, she doesn't. She looks too. She doesn't. She looks too Anglo.
Yeah, like a white storm.
A white storm.
Yeah, whitewash storm. Why not?
Aurora.
That's what made me super popular with the kids.
Like that drawing of Black Panther with a white guy in the suit?
That's not going to go over well.
Yeah. You know what's funny is if they did a like a Babylon Bee article on the on the Gal Gadot thing, it says the cast of Hamilton is irate about Gal Gadot Bee. Or
yeah, that's hilarious.
Is that true?
No, it's Babylon Bee.
Thought it'd be funny.
It's big.
But it is retweeted by Trump, so.
Yeah, that was funny.
It was. It's still up. No one told him to correct it.
Yeah. I think he was trolling people.
Probably.
Let's see. I Hate Cecil wants to know if he could still buy Lone Star 1 and 2.
Yeah, just get on over to magus7.com. Those books get here on Monday. I've set the appointment for delivery, and so I'll be in fulfillment all next week.
Cool. You gonna live stream it?
I don't know.
When is Mike never gonna live stream something?
Yeah, I know, that's true.
Mike would live stream, you know, taking fruit off the trees.
You know? And I have.
Yeah.
Mike, have you live streamed the bathroom experience yet?
Don't give me any ideas.
I know. And he's like, well, actually.
Be more specific. Which experience?
I want to see Mike S. Miller brushing his teeth. How about that? Who wants to see that?
I'm still trying to get over Doug Tenapel live streaming himself coming home from the hospital after the surgery. I was like, dang.
That worked pretty grim.
That guy is like, he's all in. 2K
HP. All right. Put it back on Mike. This is what Mike's doing.
Oh, are you?
Because you didn't help me at all, Micah.
Oh, you mean you need that know who that that right pretty there. Girl should be?
It's okay. It's okay. I was trying not to think.
I'm thinking like Emma Frost now.
Emma? Her hair's too full.
She looks kind of like a bad girl.
Peg Bundy.
She's got her eyes all over somebody's mortgage, it looks like.
Spoken like a divorced man.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Like, don't worry, Jeremiah. My husband won't find out about you.
Oh, no.
Oh, gee, this is too much. TMI. TMI.
Steer away from the skid. Steer away from the skid.
This is the night the Mecca starts. This is called, they're going to label this the leather couch. Therapy night on Blacklist Universe.
Oh no, I love my ex-wife.
that might be the problem.
I love my dead gay son.
What? You got your gay son, Mike? What?
Oh, I guess you've never seen Heathers.
No, somebody told me I need to watch.
I didn't like Heathers. I didn't like it.
Shut up right now.
Sorry.
I said I only watch Marvel movies. And tell that to any film snob and they go ballistic.
So the main character is a psychopathic
killer.
And he kind of kills a couple of the kids in school and then writes this suicide note saying that they were found dead and nearly naked together in the parking lot, or not the parking lot, in the woods.
I know, right?
And so at the funeral, the dad's like, my son was gay. I love a dead gay son.
Terrible.
What? It's a great movie.
No.
What do you know?
I can go over the glorification of murder in that movie.
Okay, that's like half of Hollywood.
Yeah,
that's my weekends. What are you talking about?
Yeah. And it wasn't glorified. That's why freaking Veronica was there to make note of that he was a crazy psychopath.
I know, but
that she wasn't going down that road with him.
Yeah,
I don't know.
I couldn't get into it.
Trying to figure out if this Borat sequel got released or not.
Oh, yeah. Whatever happened with that?
I think it's either out or coming out. And,
thanks. That helps.
Is anyone even going to the theaters now? I don't know.
I went and saw Akira a couple weeks back. That was cool.
You did? Oh, cool.
Yeah. That was a good experience. And, my brother went and saw Empire Strikes Back and Friday the 13th.
Oh, wow.
I'm like, well, that makes more sense to me because movies suck today anyway, so might as well go back to the good ones.
I was looking forward to seeing the new James Bond movie, though. They pushed that back until April.
Yeah.
So I'm like, ah, dang it.
The only good thing about that movie looked like the Bond girls in it. Ana de Armas.
Oh, yeah.
Who?
Yeah.
I was going to ask you guys, what happened to Batman? Did that guy quit?
No, he didn't quit. He apparently he got COVID, but now they're saying that he didn't get COVID. He was just too scrawny, and the director made him take a month off to work out.
Nice. Isn't that what happened to Batwoman on CW?
Oh, right. Is that started yet? Because the original girl quit.
Yeah, she quit. She said that she was sick, too.
Yeah.
And
she was sick of the CW.
So yeah, pretty much.
Patton Oswalt's not Batman anymore.
No, he still is.
I'd like to see that. No, I don't know if I want to. No,
that'd be hilarious. I would like to see him as a penguin, but
oh, that's a good choice.
But put him in a suit. Put him in a Batman suit. That'd be awesome.
That's a good use of a nobody.
Well, he would have been good, I think. I mean, it's like Colin Farrell. Is he playing the Penguin or is he playing like a mobster? I can't tell in this new Batman movie.
Same thing.
Well, I don't know. Is he? Who's the Riddler?
I don't know who's playing the Riddler. I can't remember.
I'll be honest with you. I don't even care.
Yeah, me either. Because they got the guy from Twilight to play Batman. I was like, forget it. That's garbage.
I really liked, you know what it is for me, man? It's that crazy costume. It ruins it. Looks like he's got like a weird sinus problem. It's weirdly pinched at the right under the cheekbone. I don't like it at all. It looks like trash.
Yeah.
I have a very like specific aesthetic for that. Like I have to be, Batman has to look a certain way. That doesn't cut it for me.
Yeah.
I don't mean to be a snob. I'm a Batman snob.
That's good. I mean, Hollywood needs more Batman snobs when they're making their movies because their movies are not the best.
Well, they're not making any movies anymore, apparently.
Yeah.
Well, they should stop.
Making movies?
Yeah. Mix up those songs. Yeah, I don't know. The effeminate Batman wasn't working for me either.
Effeminate?
I don't think he's being a
Batman. Pattinson, he's
very effeminate. He's very soft.
I didn't think he was effeminate.
He's like anti-male, honestly. He's going to come out a couple years as a...
No, there's a difference between metrosexual and effeminate.
Metrosexual does not... It doesn't work for Batman.
No.
I might work for Bruce Wayne. Maybe. It does work for Bruce Wayne.
I don't think so.
It does.
That works for Zorro and the Gay Blade.
On this one.
I just think that I don't mind him as I didn't mind him at first because I saw him in I love this movie the Lighthouse.
Oh, Lighthouse, yeah.
I love that
movie. Stop botting!
He was great, but then when I saw him, he just his that weird haircut. I don't get these people, man. They don't get Batman. He had this dumb haircut. He clearly you can't wear if you do all the work it's going to take. Do you know how much work Bruce Wayne has to do to get that hair pulled back? He looks retarded. And then when he's in the other way, when he's wearing the suit, he looks like a skinny guy in a book. His neck is skinny. You can't fix that. So
he looks like a bad cosplayer.
Who?
He looks like a bad cosplayer.
Yeah, eat a sandwich, dude. Put some mayonnaise on there and rock and roll. Let's go.
Yeah.
You can make it happen. Give me my Batman, please.
Thank you. What annoyed me was that during when they took a break because of COVID back in spring, you know, they stopped filming for like 6 months. He was bragging about not working out.
That was a joke.
Huh?
That was a joke.
It wasn't funny.
I don't think it was.
No,
it was,
Okay. We're not laughing, Robert.
I can't remember who he was targeting, but he was trying to make somebody like cringe or some crap like that. So that was literally a joke he was pulling on somebody else and using the media.
I don't think it was a joke, honestly.
That's what I would say if I got caught in a bad joke.
Yeah.
It was unfunny.
Yeah. I mean,
Robert.
Whatever. Everybody said that freaking Heath Ledger would be a terrible Joker until they saw him.
And he was.
Well, watch your mouth, mister.
Joker. I'll tell you why he's a terrible Joker. Because he was a great villain, but he was not a Joker. He was a great psycho. He was a great, you know, he did a good job of playing somebody else. But I like him. Just saying. No. Take that to the bank, Michael. The jerkmonger's here. The monger you love to hate. I'm here.
Oh, yay. Speaking of taking the bank, I took Eden to the bank today. She got her own bank account. So,
yay. Did you pay her so she had money to put in it?
I have to take the... Shut up. I have to take the thing down. And now if anybody wants to send Eden money for her birthday, you can just send her at Eden Lorna.
Or you could support her YouTube channel she was supposed to make.
She's a... Her PayPal is at Eden Lorna. Kill me.
Is she enjoying 18?
Yeah, she likes doing all the adult stuff that she couldn't do.
Like paying rent.
Charger.
Hey, she signed up for selective service yet, Michael?
Really?
Yeah. Right.
Come on, man. Come on.
You gotta do it.
Everyone's pitching.
She's a girl.
Shh, don't tell her.
No, she's not a girl. She's a young lady.
Up for it.
She's a girl, and she ain't signing up for selective service.
Tell her she has to sign up for the Army now.
We're all the same, aren't we?
Come on.
We're not.
JJ. Have her join the Army artist group.
Over there. In prayer.
It's over there, duty.
Beware. Because the Yanks are coming.
It's on.
Are coming, ladies are coming over. I love this.
Started smoking. No, she did not start smoking. Gosh, you guys are the worst.
Well, you have to be 21 to buy cigarettes here anyway.
What?
Yeah, they raised the age on that a couple years back.
Hogwash. Seriously?
Yeah, yeah. Buying cigarettes at 21 now.
I think so, yeah.
See,
is that nationwide or is that
for your buy for your cancer sticks?
I'm just saying, is she signed up for voting already?
Yeah.
Oh snap! One more, baby. Come on.
Yeah, man. Got to get Kanye.
Oh my god!
Oh my god! I saw that. I was like,
stop, Kanye. Mike, don't do it, Mike.
I don't know what to do,
dude. My vote is worthless here. I seriously.
Mike, don't do it.
I like it. So those vote counters are like, there's Republicans still here? What's up with that?
That's kind of true. I'm surprised. You guys had a parade the other day in L.A.
What kind of parade?
A Trump parade. You see that? Right? Yeah, dude.
I don't live in L.A.
Yeah.
Well, it's close enough. What are you talking about?
Close enough for what?
Actually, not close enough at all. You guys are like miles and miles apart, right?
Yeah, that's hundreds of miles. Well, is it about 120 miles to LA?
That's what's that? 4 hours? 5 hours?
No, it should be about 2 hours.
Stop whining.
Except for traffic.
So wait, stop
what?
Dare stop you. What? Whining. Hello.
What's whining about what? You want me to drive to LA for a Trump?
If you're committed to it, yeah.
Dude, I don't drive across town to see my parents. That's not
good. Oh, I got the guilt trip today from my mom. Mm-hmm. I would like to see my grandkids more than 3 times a year. and on the tip of my tongue was like, but I live down the road. No, don't do it.
Yeah. You're right. My mom does it too. And she's like 8 minutes away. I'm like, you know, it's a lot easier for you to come here than it is to bring my entire family to your tiny apartment.
Oh well, it
carries you for 9 months, Mike. You can take 5 minutes to drive to her place.
Shut up.
That's the kind of conversation I have with my mom. She's like, you just shut your mouth.
Like my mom too.
So I'm going over there tomorrow. I hope to go there tomorrow. I hate COVID. You know, I just had a little, like, I was like, man, the weather's shifting around here. And I was feeling a little under the weather. My daughter has runny nose. And I'm like, it's just the fall. Dang it.
Every little thing. It's like, is it COVID? Scary. It's annoying.
Yeah, no, everyone just has allergies now.
We're all going to die.
What? Yeah, the death rate is 100%.
That's true.
Yep. And it always attacks the healthiest, most preventative people. That's corona.
I'm just saying death.
My corona.
One of my favorite lines from an animation called Fire and Ice.
Oh, yeah.
Don't hunt for death, boy. It finds us all soon enough.
That is true.
It is true. I got a trophy. All right. She's got hair. Yeah,
she knows how to use. Oh, wait.
She's got breasticles. I still don't know who she is. They're a little low, though.
January
came.
Lola.
I'm going to make her.
Lola.
Should I make her a mermaid?
No. Mermaids are stupid.
No, they're not stupid. You hold your tongue, boy.
What's your mouth?
They take the idea of a woman and they just destroy it, you know?
Do they really? Do they really? Or maybe you just got a problem. Maybe you got to get off of mermaids.com. All right, so I think, Mike, who should she be? Come on. You got a
turn it into like a scorpion tail with like a stinger.
Oh, I want to. I don't want to invent a new character. That's too hard.
Spider Woman.
Oh.
That looks like a Bridgman drawing.
Bridgman?
Looks like a Hips McGee.
Oh, I just like the hips, man.
Oh, hey, did you show Mr. Dead in His Pocket the cover?
Who?
Mr. Dudna's Pocket. I know you're doing a commission for him, so I was wondering if you showed
him. Yes.
The cover.
And that has been taken care of.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, that's helping.
Egg salad.
Egg salad. Yummy, yummy.
Hey, Micah. I said 10 o'clock. It's almost 11. End it now, boy.
So this is Spider-Woman. Maybe she's got... maybe this is Spider-Woman in a... In her swimsuit. This is the Marvel swimsuit issue
that they're going. Ooh, yes.
What if she was like Tarantula Woman?
Yeah. What does that mean, Micah? That's not even English. Bro.
It's like Spider Woman, but like more.
It's Spider Woman, but hairy.
With hairy legs, yeah. What?
I go swimming with hairy women.
Sure. You know how sleek and sexy Black Widow spiders are? Tarantulas.
They kill their mates. And this woman looks like she's already come after my bank account. All $12 of it.
My father used to say, a woman like that could destroy your life if you're lucky.
If you're lucky.
My dad, it's funny. With his weird Puerto Rican accent. My dad has the weirdest Puerto Rican accent because I literally can't imitate it. I don't know what he's saying. He moved to New York when he was 18 years old.
Uh-huh. So he's got mud accent.
What he has is somehow I forget the story, but somehow my grandfather helped him get a job at Bronx Lebanon Hospital, and back then you could become, you know, you could either study or you could do on the job training, and he did on the job training for that role, and he became a respiratory therapist for years. He was a respiratory therapist. Then when we moved down here, he needed more qualifications, so he went back to school. But anyway, what was I saying?
I don't know.
Tell him about your
father. So he learned his English. His English is a mixed not languages, dialects. Like he learned not dialects, but accents. Like he learned English from Indian doc and Tagalog from the Filipino doctors. So he's got a weird, weird like pattern. I can't imitate it.
No, I get it. My my ex sister in law is Australian, but she moved to was it Arkansas?
Arkansas.
Yeah, when she first moved to America, she moved to like the deep south, and so her Australian and her Australian picked up some southern, and now you're like, you have the worst accent on her.
So she sounds South African.
Like nobody wants to hear you talk.
Yeah, South African
stuff. I love accents.
That's poor woman, Michael. That's not even cool.
That's fine. She's terrible. I mean,
yeah, but she just ruined her life. She
yeah, she's horrible.
Aw.
I never liked her anyway.
Oh, no. That goes without saying, my friend.
All right. She's got too much butt, though. I'm gonna have to trim off some butt. She's going to liposuction surgery.
There is such a thing as too much butt.
Yeah, doing the butt.
I never found Kim Kardashian attractive.
What?
Never.
What?
After all the money she spent on plastic surgery.
Couldn't impress me.
She's attractive. She's just trash.
I think she's attractive too.
Who?
Kim Kardashian?
I'm more of a Taylor Swift guy.
No. I mean, she's attractive too, but she's trash.
Kim is married to the future president of the United States.
That is true.
That dude just put out a campaign ad, didn't he?
Who, Kanye?
Yeah.
That's what we're talking about. He's inspirational. I'm not going to lie.
They haven't shown it on MSNBC. I haven't seen it.
All right. I feel like I need to
Everyone's making fun of me for the
characters on this cover.
Well, let's see it. We're not seeing.
What do you have so far? What do you got?
Let's see it, Mike.
Just use mine. I got the whole list. I have a list here still. You want it? I'll email it to you.
I have your piece. I don't need it.
You're saying you need more
the lizard. Characters? The lizard?
Yeah, I need to like.
You got lizards, right?
I don't know. Do you think it'd be too much if I covered up? Because Gormando would start getting covered up if I just start adding more and more characters.
You can have more.
They'd all be behind him anyway.
Where's your title going to go on that cover?
I'm not worried about the title.
Put Crash.
Is it just me? But I think also.
Why does everyone have to be so picky about titles?
You asked for input.
Not about that.
You know, it's like the critiques, Mike. If you can't handle it,
exactly.
Oh. Space for a title. Are you happy now?
We need a Mike clone to critique Mike.
Oh, screen. Yeah, you almost don't have anything. Yeah, you're not going to see any of that hand.
You got to do that WWJLD thing.
What? Dude, I'm going to freaking boot you from this.
Oh, how dare you? I'm back on Mike's team. You shut your mouth, Mecca.
Oh, I'm yelling for the night. I'm sorry. I think Jim Lee's overrated.
Of course he is. I didn't say that. I read it all over Twitter. Anyway.
Oh, no. I was just looking at some of the X-Men stuff he did. I'm like, I don't really like this.
All right. How do I make this Spider-Woman now? I gave her a swimsuit.
Got to go Tarantula Woman.
Why give her a swimsuit if she's Spider-Woman?
Because she's sunning. It's a different day.
Spiders are nocturnal.
All right, well, her hair should be black, obviously.
Yeah.
Right, that's fine. But what can I do to the costume? I don't want to put diamonds.
Swimsuit.
Give her spider web boobs.
Hey, Elliot, give her like a chest of a chesticle window in the shape of her
good
yellow diamond.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
And that was Mary Jane Watson.
No. Make it a one-piece bathing suit, and then have like an open window in the shape of that yellow diamond she has on her costume.
Hmm. Dang it! All the work I did.
Or not.
No, it's erasing right now. I just gotta figure out where I'm gonna stop.
Just start over, Elliot. It's all right.
Stop. Don't start over. Give her the dark hair. Make her swimsuit red.
You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just start over.
Stop. Mike, don't listen to Mike.
Well, I gotta move on. I gotta move on anyway. I gotta start working on this commission, but I'll keep working on the Cowboy Bebop thing. Maybe she's got. Does she have a tattoo? I love Peter Parker.
No. Oh, is this going to be Mary Jane now?
I don't know. It could be. It's probably better as Mary Jane.
Yeah, if it's Mary Jane, give her a tattoo. If it's Spider-Woman, do not.
She's like, Peter, where are you? Where's my suntan lotion? Right here.
Will Mary Jane have a tramp stamp?
You know, maybe she does. She's a bit of a rebel. Maybe she's got a tiger.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Face
uh-huh.
a tiger.
That'd be awesome.
See?
Yeah, give her a tiger tram stamp.
But you can't see her.
That would be Mary Jane.
Yeah, how are you supposed to see her tramp stamp? It's freaking behind her.
Yeah. So don't worry about it.
Not even Milo Manara can make that happen.
Yes. He could do it.
He could. He possibly could. Because no woman could ever pose that way.
That's a lot of... Oh, my gosh. Marvel's so dumb.
It wasn't Marvel, man. It was Marvel. Listen.
It was Marvel.
I know. I'm just saying. I was trying to give them some grace.
They don't deserve it.
It's true.
They lost all my grace when they had Spider-Man make a literal deal with the devil.
Dealing with the devil.
It's like, if you save my 95-year-old aunt, I'll give you my marriage and my unborn child.
Okay, sounds good to me.
To a literal supermodel.
Idiot.
Let's just forget all about that stuff about great power and great responsibility. Just have Spider-Man do something completely out of character.
We want him to be young again.
Listen, Peter's not that smart, man. We proved it with Superior Spider-Man.
Hmm.
Dr. Octopus is clearly the superior.
Sadly, he was.
No, nothing.
Thanks. Well, until he wasn't.
Jimmy wants to throw out something at me, but he can't figure out how to get it through the monitor.
Terrible.
This is terrible? What are you
talking about? No. One more day.
I think the chat...
I like the drawing.
People are still mad about One More Day.
Good, they should be.
What's One More Day?
Stop it, Mike.
Well, it's been like 25 years, man.
It doesn't matter.
I don't know. Did you guys see the story for the Spider-Man PS4 game? Because Mary Jane was just about insufferable in that
thing. She was annoying as heck. Oh, God, I hated her.
Like, I would go play that game. I'd sit down and be like, oh, I just want to swing around, you know, cool off work. And then all of a sudden, it's like,
the worst.
It's so cool.
Oh, gosh. They turned Mary Jane into, like, a shrewish Lois Lane clone.
Yeah, and then, like, Peter's flying around, and he's juggling his cell phone, like, oh, what's she going to think?
She had broken up with Peter before the game even started, okay? So they're on the outs. They're not even dating anymore because she broke up with him. And she spends the entire game hectoring him, nagging him, complaining about him while making him go on these stupid missions for her so she can get, like, some scoop for the Daily Bugle. It's annoying as heck.
Yeah, don't you hate it when people just sit there and complain the whole time?
Yeah. I hate that.
Wait a minute.
I could do that for hours. Yeah, and she was ugly, too.
Yeah, she was. It wasn't like she was hot. Yeah,
They go and remaster the game, and they change Peter's face, but they couldn't fix Mary Jane's.
Exactly. They made a mistake. They picked the wrong character. It's like they took – remember the movie played Mary Jane in the last Spider-Man movie when it was with Sony? She had like a really –
Kirsten?
Huh?
Kirsten?
No, it was a girl who starred in
Shailene Woodley.
Those Divergent series.
Yeah, Shailene Woodley.
Yeah, her face is like, oh my gosh. She has like a, she's not attractive, let's put it that way.
Her face looks like a butt, and her butt looks like a face.
And wow. They hired her to play Mary Jane Watson, and I was like, what?
Yeah.
Mary Jane Watson is supposed to be a supermodel. This girl looks like the unattractive checkout girl at your local deli.
Yeah, and she has like a collection of indie music.
Oh.
And it's not bad. Good.
But that's who who it looks like they modeled the PS4 Spider-Man game Mary Jane after.
Yeah, and then it's like they fed her like a bunch of buttered biscuits.
What the heck?
And she got fat in the face.
Y'all are so judgmental.
Yeah.
So ugly.
I am. When it comes to CGI characters, I am very judgmental.
It's okay. I'm ugly on the inside.
We know, Mike.
But the game was cool, but Mary Jane was a pain in the annoying.
Yeah. Yeah, hopefully the new one is going to be better.
Was a new one coming out? Oh, is that the one with Miles Morales? Yeah.
Well, they're remastering the PS4 version too for the.
I'll skip that. I'll be skipping that one.
Yeah.
Things you never take.
Miles Morales.
I had to get a
piece. They made him a new character and then, like, oh, let's give him Venom shocking powers. Because Spider-Man needed an electricity upgrade.
Why are
you going to have those powers forever?
Stream!
He said he wanted to go away for a minute.
Yes, but then he came back and he's not there.
Elliot?
Yeah, I was here for like 25 minutes.
Oh, man.
Hmm? All I could hear was Jiminy complaining and right? Mecca was agreeing.
Very dynamic.
Wake up suddenly. You're in love.
Okay, I gotta move on. This is taking up too much time. All right. It's fun. Dude. I'll come back to it later.
That's what I'm saying.
It'll be the swimsuit issue.
Look what I got. Let's see what I got.
I can't see anything. And you guys sound like robots to me. Is that my connection?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Oh!
Very nice.
That's great.
Are those patches or stickers?
Stickers. Stickers.
Nice. Oh, I can't wait to throw those away.
No, these are for my channel members.
Aw, oh, man.
First Brigade?
Or First Brigade.
No, they're for my channel members.
Well, no, First Brigade are the ones who...
They're for my channel members.
Did you have a members-only stream yesterday?
I did.
What?
I can't believe you.
What? Are members you not a member anymore? Jiminy, type something in the chat. Mr. Dead in His Pocket, member, says, yay!
Member.
Member. Yeah, so I'm gonna be sending out a message asking for all the members to send me an address I can ship those to.
You could add mine to the links you're supposed to send.
Every member will get their patch. Or not their patch, a sticker. And their vinyl stickers. Cool, huh? Ooh.
Nice.
My wake up on my Cintiq. Cintiq's got a sticker on it.
I just replaced the nib on mine, and it feels like I'm sliding around on an ice rink or something.
Sting.
Must be that new nib smell.
Suddenly, I've never bothered changing a nib.
Well, mine was like really scratchy, so I was like, oh, it must be time, and I've got 8 other ones just sitting here.
Yeah, I've got them sitting here. I've never bothered replacing one.
The tool to change it is it's in that little ink pot thing.
I have it. That's right here. Yeah. I
didn't know this, but you're supposed to unscrew it, and it's like hiding in the inside of it.
I just want to know where the heck Weldon is. Just given up on us? Is that what's going on here?
Shameful.
What's his YouTube handle?
Who, Matt?
Yeah.
What? Weldon Art?
Weldon Art.
Okay, I'm going to at him and see if he's lurking.
Yes.
Okay, no, he's not watching.
Let me call him again.
Probably using one of his sock accounts.
Yep. Mr. Jerk. Are you there?
Word.
Elliot.
I didn't know this. Apparently somebody had done a pilot of a Mike Mignola property. Did you ever see that?
A what?
Mike Mignola had a pilot for a cartoon. It was about like a skeleton butler or something.
Is it The Amazing Scrawny Head?
Yeah, I think that was it. Now, I'm just starting to appreciate Mignola's art, but seeing it animated, just wow.
Other samples of it?
Yeah, there's like a clip I found.
Oh, really? On YouTube?
Yeah, let me see if I can find it.
I'll
do that, yeah.
The whole thing's on YouTube.
Really? Huh.
Yeah.
I didn't even know about it.
What's it called, Mr. Screw-On Head?
The Amazing Screw-On Head.
Yeah, just check that out. It's pretty amazing to look at.
Sounds amazing.
Mignola's...
It is fantastic.
Yeah. But seeing it animated...
It's very funny.
Just...
It's got Giamatto. Paul Giamatto is, I think, the voice of the Screw-On Head.
Yeah.
He works for Abraham Lincoln.
He works for Abraham Lincoln.
Yeah, yeah. It's very cool. And I crack up. At one point in the story, the villain is freaked out by something, and he says, "I think I've soiled my pantaloons." I crack up every time I hear it. Sorry. It's the little things in life.
You laugh at people's incontinence?
No, just a zombie guy.
Oh, he's a zombie.
He's got zombie poop, bro.
So you're racist against zombies now. I see how
you are. No, they're just dead versions of us. They're not different race at all. Anyway. Should I draw this traditional? But she needs to be doing something. There's no story here. I'm just angry, and I don't know why. I need Peter Parker in here fast.
I thought you stopped working on that because you had something important.
You said you had a commission, didn't you?
Yeah. Because I can't, because it's so cool. I want to keep it going, but I shouldn't. You know how it goes. Come on, man. All right, I'm done.
She looks like she could go on the back of like a the thing that go over truck tires.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, yeah.
She's like a flap girl.
All right, here we go. I need my reference now for the rest of the Cowboy Bebop team.
Bebop. Beep, bebop.
I'm also trying to close windows because I think it's affecting like the audio sounds terrible here right now. You guys.
You're running out of range.
Especially with my ear thing.
You sound okay. Maybe.
And what else do I have open then? I'll quit that too.
I don't know
one what MC after one
looks like because Weldon's supposed to design her.
Well done, sir.
So I just have to draw a female figure here.
Can I ask an art question real quick?
No.
Do you draw from your wrist or from your fingers?
Yes.
So both. I say both, yeah.
Sometimes from my elbow.
One thing I learned wrong when I was growing up was playing guitar. I used to always pick with my thumb and finger when it's really supposed to be more of a wrist motion. So I'm trying to avoid a similar pitfall as I endeavor upon this artistic crusade.
Yeah. For me, it depends on how small an area I'm drawing. If I'm doing like detail work, I'm drawing with my fingers. If I'm drawing wider, my wrist,
wider still with my elbow, like Mike. So it just depends on the size of or the area that you're drawing. Drawing
a long line or something.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. I think I've been all finger this whole time. Yeah. But I haven't given up yet.
Don't give up.
Nope. One day I will.
Yeah, the rest of your life to keep training. So.
One day I'll be eviscerated on the Saturday night show.
Yes.
I can't go on.
See, I think a lot of people should realize that having a critique go on for more than a couple minutes on the show would itself be a compliment.
Mm. Who's the girl, Mike?
That's a new character. That's Ooh. Her appearance in this. And
okay.
Weldon.
The Jawbreaker female?
Weldon is supposed to have designed her, but she hasn't.
Is she, unknown soldier? Yes.
She's an unknown.
Unknown he's soldier. A secret.
The unknown soldiers are boys.
Nice.
She's a super freak.
Says Michael.
Super freak.
I'm a misogynist. No girls in the unknown soldiers.
You should take back that that female you made for the Jawbreakers and put her in this.
Seance is dead.
Seance.
He fridged her. Mike fridged her.
I hope you fridged her gloriously.
I fridged her so good. She's right in there with my fillet of fish.
Well, yeah. McFish.
Terrible. Terrible.
I don't know if Weldon's going to give this chick a cape or anything, so I probably maybe I should just leave her out.
Mike, how many? Just so Matthew Weldon knows what to do. How many months pregnant is she?
She's not pregnant.
Like, story. No, she's pregnant or
not pregnant. Don't leave me this way. I can't go on. All right. Hothead. Throw some Hothead on the cover over here.
Who's that?
Hothead. Jeremiah Jones' favorite character, Hothead.
Oh, Hothead. Okay, gotcha. Where's his name? Preacher or priest or?
Pastor.
Pastor. I knew it was something like that.
Or
Reverend, what's his name?
Gosh, I don't remember if you put him in the book. You remember the script? He certainly doesn't have a big enough role in the book to remember if he's in there. Pastor.
Who is it?
Pastor.
He's not in the script that I can tell.
Okay, yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah. Can you hear me? Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now?
I'm just, I think I might even be delayed.
Can you hear me? Yes. Can you hear me now?
Yes. I should hear now too.
Yep, yep, yep.
Time Magazine put out a list of 100 best fantasy books of all time. Apparently it's pretty bad.
What's bad?
The 100 best fantasy books of all time, according to Time Magazine.
Are pretty bad.
What they put on there.
I'm going to have to find out.
What's on the list?
Let me see.
Number one's probably Twilight.
Oh, I got it. Let's see here.
No!
Stop.
Arabian Nights, Adventures of Wonderland, Through the Looking Glass, Mary
Body Poppins. Is a Wonderland.
Lion, Witch, and the Wardrobe, Fellowship of the Ring, Don Treader, James and the Giant Peach, Wrinkle in Time.
So far, so good.
Yeah, not too bad. Watership Down.
Oh, yes.
Princess Bride.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
The BFG by Roald Dahl.
Okay, cool.
Which was a movie that no one cared about.
That was a great movie.
no one cared about it.
I love BFG.
The Atheist and the Wardrobe, is really? Or Golden Compass by Philip Pullman.
Yeah.
Neverwhere by Neil Gaiman. Ella Enchanted. Ugh.
Meh.
Harry Potter. Oh, get out of here.
Harry Potter.
Harry Potter was pretty good.
I like Potter.
Harry Potter.
Ugh. You're a wizard, Harry.
I'm so glad we've never done that for D&Q.
Oh, man, that'd be fun.
Oh. No.
What's that? Which is
Harry
that
Potter.
One?
Potter. Harry Potter.
Oh, yeah, we should do Potter. I like Potter.
That'd be great.
I don't know. This doesn't seem too bad, actually. A lot of stuff I haven't heard of course. Yeah, that ain't too bad. I don't know what anyone would be mad about that for.
It gives me hope.
I'm sure someone will find a reason.
I don't know. It's got enough Tolkien and Lord of the Rings on there. I didn't see Twilight. Passes the sniff test.
See if Lewis.
The Atheist in the Wardrobe.
The Atheist in the Wardrobe.
Yeah, the Golden Compass. It was like the atheist version of was that the
yeah wow. he wrote it as sort of an atheist response to the Narnia series.
Why would you have an atheist response to the Narnia series?
Because this guy is an atheist and he has a god bug up his butt. So
yeah, it was a big controversy when that Golden Compass movie came out.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's why it failed because people didn't want to support it.
They had like the polar bears in it and stuff.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
I started watching the new version of it. They I think it was HBO started putting out a new version.
Yeah. Dark Materials.
Yeah. Last year, it was okay. But yeah, kind of lost interest after a few episodes.
Yeah, I don't blame you. It takes a lot for me to get interested in good things in the first place. So.
Right. Yeah. I wish they had continued with the Narnia series. They were pretty close to, well, they got halfway through.
Aren't somebody doing that? I just saw an ad for something like that.
Yeah, a Netflix series?
Yeah.
Does anyone in the chat know? Do they have a Chronicles of Narnia Netflix show?
Aren't they doing a Lord of the Rings show?
Amazon is.
That was on Amazon. Huh? Not sure how far they are with that. I don't even know if they started it yet.
So it hasn't come out at all yet?
No.
Okay, good.
Last anyone heard of it, they were talking about adding nudity to it.
No.
And gratuitous romance scenes.
Only if they're hot elves.
I don't
female, have female elves.
I don't.
Apparently the writer's room was the typical SJW nonsense. So.
Okay, yeah. I'll probably skip
never had much hope for you.
Listen. I can't take all this complaining.
Do you know a secret?
You know what it was? It was my Facebook window. It was destroying my feed. Stupid Facebook.
Stupid.
Speaking of which,
ba-ding! Yeah. Mr. Complaining over here. Dun 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 dun.
All right. Who else needs to be on here?
Just wait till they get to the live action merge.
The live action what?
Naruto.
Yeah, another guy here. Nobody's gonna know who it is. But I'm gonna slip him in anyways. Only Elliot will know who he is.
Space Ghost?
Rutger Hauer.
Oh yeah.
Rutger Hauer.
Oh yeah. You don't even know. You don't even know.
You don't even know, Mecca.
Mm-mm.
Where is the love? Where is the love? It's too late for singing, Elliot. What's wrong with you?
It's never too late for singing.
It's never too late for singing. So I parted ways with my artwork for Naruto today.
You did?
Yeah, I sent it off. I sent it off to someone for as a gift.
Aww.
You know, there was someone's celebration of their day of birth was recent. Are you aware of this?
Yeah, my daughter.
Yes, and a certain Oregonian.
Oregonian. Oh, right.
All right. So how's this coming along, Jiminy? Are you liking this face for our old girl?
Jiminy.
Yeah.
He's a talking to you.
I'm talking because you know more about this anime stuff than most of the guys here.
Okay, yeah. Hit me.
That's Faye?
Yeah, it's Faye Valheim.
Yeah, that's a good Faye.
All right.
On point.
He's all bitter because he didn't ask him.
Because I did what?
Because he didn't ask Mecca.
Mecca, are you bitter?
No.
Mecca, why are you pretending, man? Come on. Come clean.
So Ellie, is this one big piece or are these separate commissions?
Yeah, it's they're all the characters are in one image.
Okay, cool. Nice.
But if it's a commission, you eventually have to do it traditionally, right?
Yeah, I'm just laying things out, trying to figure it. I don't want to put
any. Can you just, like, delete the file and call it an original?
You know what? You're laughing, but that's coming. They're called NFTs, non-fungible tokens.
Really? Yeah,
that's something that's happening on blockchain right now. People are actually buying and selling stuff that's digital for real money.
Wow.
We got to look into that because I think that's like a space that if we're early into that space, we could be biggie wiggies.
Well, how would we be big wigs in that?
Just like, you know, being the guys that were the first people to plant their flags on YouTube.
Oh, I gotcha. Yeah, that would solve a lot of the problem for a lot of these collectors, I guess. But it stays rough and I do some other drawing with it. I don't want to redraw eyeballs and erase too much. I prefer to make my mistakes on the digital side and then I'll go in and I'll transfer it and I'll start adding different things. I'll draw some more. And then I ink. And then it's time to ink, no? It's very good? Very nice? Do you like the inky?
Uncle Julio. Nice to see you from the paranormal show. How are you?
Who's that?
Oh, I thought Uncle Julio just stopped by.
It's an Italiano. He's different from a Tio Julio. What's wrong with you? It's Mario, Luigi. Why are you breaking your head? I love that little cartoon when Luigi Mario hits his head on the bricks. It was from that guy from College Humor.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Look it up. College Humor. College Humor did a thing where Mario, it's a little cartoon short. It's like 2 minutes long. Mario comes out, and he hits his head in the bricks, but it's like realistic. So he gets hurt. He gets hurt. And then, so he's like, so Luigi comes out and goes, no, Mario, why you hurt your head? He goes, no, I jump in the bricks and they didn't hurt my head. So then Luigi runs over and goes, what do you mean? And he jumps up and cracks his neck. He dies. Why you die?
Stop. How horrible you are.
Cartoon death is the best. Anyway.
You must have liked those Happy Tree Friends back in the day, huh?
Who?
Happy Tree Friends?
I don't know what that is.
It was like a web series where they just had a bunch of animals killing each other.
What?
Yeah.
Aww. Oh, no, it's specific cartoon death. You know, and this is the voice. No, Mario, why you doing? No, no. Why you breaking your head?
We're breaking your head.
So that's my favorite. That's my favorite fake Italian voice.
No, no, you die. We heard a story about that guy getting that job.
What?
The story behind that guy getting that job.
No.
Yeah, he was like, I can't remember if he was like, basically they were about to end. He like got there late and they had already seen all these people and they're like, he's like, oh, you know, I came to read for that part. And they're like, fine.
Oh, then, no.
Like, yeah, you do, you know, he's all, what is it? He's like, you know, it's like an Italian, you know, plumber, blah, blah, blah. And he just made that ridiculous voice. And they're like, they like drop their papers on the floor and they're like, grab their phones. They're like, we got it. We got it. This is the voice.
What part was that for?
For Mario.
In the game?
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
Are you talking about Martinet?
Is that his name?
Charles Martinet, yeah.
Look at you.
Let's go.
I'm going to get all nerdy little games.
He just Googled it. Come on.
Oh, no, I knew that one.
No. How come you didn't know the story?
I think you're just making that story up.
That's great.
The sad part is that they found out he wasn't actually Italian and they fired him.
They
figured it out now. No.
I'm kidding.
They figured out he wasn't Italian when he had this horribly racist Italian accent.
Like that Italian guy that used to play.
That's perfect.
Dude, that's not racist. I don't know what you're talking about. That is so cool.
It's Mario. I love it. If we could also Bob, that would be just perfect. Do you have a pizza? Do you have a pizza pie? I love it. Luigi, no!
Mario's gonna get you. Mario's gonna get you guys.
Listen. It's the little things, man. It's the little things. Life is too short.
Your laugh is going to be funnier than the actual clip.
You got to watch. Look it up now.
You got to watch the clip. Expect it to be hilarious. And it's like, no, just Ellie who was hilarious. The clip is actually kind of goofy.
He's got one of those infectious laughs.
I'm sorry.
A laugh is too short.
I guess y'all had to be there.
Matrix don't mess with me.
I do a terrible McConaughey, too. By the way, I just saw recently, I just watched, finally, what do you call that thing? True Detective season one.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Some of it was harsh, man. Like, you know, I was like, some of this is, I don't know I don't know. I don't watch a lot of HBO, so I was like, this is Skinamax. But, dude, that show was great.
You liked it?
I loved it. But it was Cthulhu. That's why I was all into it.
How was that show Cthulhu?
They didn't show. Come on, man. Gosh, you know what? That's it. I'm taking your card away. It's because it was a perfect Lovecraftian story.
Really?
Well, they're making reference to the King in Yellow. The King in Yellow is a character that Robert Chambers invented.
Right.
I think I would have to argue that the Lovecraft probably popularized it with his including it in his works, but. People, you know, it's no secret that he credits, you know, everyone credits Chambers for that. But it's basically it's a cool story, man. I'm not going to get into it now because you guys are going to think I'm weird. But I know I'm weird. I just don't want to explain my weirdness and then hear people ask me questions. It's too much energy. But a really good show. Really good show. So I was impressed. You know, it's not safe for everyone in the family, but
right.
But what's interesting too is they managed to pull in the trope that Lovecraft seemed to really enjoy was making fun of the country white people. It's so funny that everyone's like, you know, he was a racist. He hated everybody that wasn't. Mm-hmm. And so whatever, but
cool.
pretty good. Whatever was happening up in upstate New York for right. Lovecraft stories, it was happening in Louisiana for that show.
Ah.
I thought it was good. You didn't like it?
I heard it was. I heard the second season really sucked, though.
I never watched it, so.
It's very, very interesting. Good detective story, good mystery, lots of red herrings, lots of things exposed and, you know, right, you know, in plain sight, but it was a good mystery stuff. It was cool.
I was wondering if they chopped down the greatest tree in the forest with that.
That's fascinating. No. I
don't know. Do you guys like
how do you chop down the greatest tree in the forest?
One chop at a time, right?
No. Whee's a herring.
What? What?
Listen.
Some people in the audience will get it and they're laughing hysterically.
Well, is this a Monty Python thing? Is that what you're doing here?
Yeah, it's a Monty Python thing.
Ugh. I knew it. If I can't get it, it's Monty Python. These British people are crazy.
Oh, okay, I got it.
Now he gets it. He's laughing. See? He gets it.
It's nervous laughter.
Nervous laughter.
I don't understand Python. That's the problem.
I thought it was that funny.
It is a huge, huge problem for the both of you.
I'm sorry, man. I just don't know. I don't. I'm sorry I didn't pass your club test. I'm sorry.
It's all right. I forgive you.
Thanks. Okay, I'm back. Okay, let's see here.
I'm a forgiving guy. I don't know if you know about that.
I've heard these things.
Wait, who's laughing?
Nothing. No, nobody.
Nobody. Wasn't me.
Better not be.
Daddy, tell me about the Boston Tea Party.
Daddy, would you like some sausage?
Daddy, are you okay? wrong song.
Do you guys like the boys ending?
I like Judge Dredd.
I kind of wish that he had just killed them all. Homelander. And I was expecting him to do that. I didn't expect him to sort of cave so easily. But, you know, I guess they want to have a third season, so.
Yeah. that kind of helps.
Yeah. If all the characters aren't killed. Yeah. But it was good. I mean, I like the fact that the son, I don't want to ruin it for anyone, but I'm going to ruin it. I kind of like the fact that the son killed the mom.
Mecca, put it on somebody else.
You got it.
But, you know, I thought it was okay.
I thought it wrapped up really nicely.
Yeah.
Compared to the first season, had that cliffhanger.
Well, I like the cliffhanger. I mean, it made you want to see the second season.
Yeah.
But
now it was like, if they got canceled, like, it would be pretty satisfying, I guess.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, they gave it a nice. It could end at this point, and it would be a satisfying ending. You know, you assume world keeps spinning. Homelander's still a scumbag, but you know he's still sort of acting like a hero to the general populace. So
yeah.
It's I mean, it's quite a bit different from the comic book, which is
definitely.
I don't think they could have filmed the comic book. It's pretty messed up.
Well, what I didn't know as I read the comic book along was, I guess all the members of the boys got a shot at Compound V in the comic.
Right. Yeah. That's the main difference. I mean, in the comic book, the boys are also super powered. So, right.
And in many cases, stronger than the average soup.
Right. Yeah. So that's. But I think that's kind of what made the TV series interesting. They didn't have that crutch.
Yeah.
You know, so they had to sort of outthink the bad guys because they obviously couldn't outpunch them. So, you know, it was an interesting show.
Mm-hmm.
I actually liked this season better than the first season.
Okay.
I don't know. I maybe because I'm used to the characters. So the first season, I was like, I don't care about any of these people.
Right. Yeah. I remember the first season. You were like, everyone on the show is a scumbag. There's no one to root for.
Yeah. They're still scumbags, but Huey seemed like less of a scumbag this season for some reason.
What's her name seemed like more of a scumbag? What's her name? Brightlight or Starlight or whatever her name is? Because she killed that guy. She has straight up murdered that one motorist who stopped to help them.
Well, she didn't murder him. They were in a bad situation.
And the guy had a baby thing in the back seat. So he was like he either just dropped off his kid at daycare or something. You know?
I totally forgot about that character.
That's terrible. I was like, oh man, she's just like the worst.
You know, I thought the
that was a self-defense moment because he was gonna shoot.
Right. So she decided to kill an innocent man.
Well, she wasn't trying to kill him.
Well,
yeah, manslaughter.
She wasn't trying to kill him. He's still dead.
You can defend her.
I don't love Satan. I just like his music.
We just wanted his car. We didn't mean to shoot him. Tell that to Uncle Ben.
Oh, poor Uncle Ben.
Poor Uncle Ben. Tell it to Spider-Man lady.
I'm not sure I want to watch that show, man. I remember when the comic came out, I was like, I don't like this idea.
Yeah, it's not as horrible as the comic book in terms of like horrible things the characters do, but it's pretty bad. But it's a good show. It's entertaining.
It's a deconstruction, you know. It's pretty cynical.
Very cynical.
But it's also kind of refreshing in that way with all these, you know, Happy Meal level of intellectual content in the Marvel movies. You know, if you're looking for something just a little more serious, The Boys ain't a bad idea. And it's fun.
It's basically... remember the like Ultraman and Superwoman from DC?
Yeah. It's a more humorous Watchmen.
Well, it has a lot of like Irredeemable in it too. Mark Waid.
Oh, right. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. I remember that comic. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, right.
Ugh. Irredeemable is my favorite comic book of all time.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh man! Wow.
So good.
I don't know who you are anymore, Mecca.
It's not often you read a comic book that actually like scares you in the same way a horror movie does.
Really? That's ridiculous. That's a trash thing. Okay.
Oh man, I don't know. I was deployed when I read it, and I was just like,
man. Yeah.
Maybe you were souped up on Agent Orange. I'm just saying.
Yeah. Compound V.
I'm just kidding. You know, I've never read the comic. I just heard about it. I was like, it just didn't sound like anything I was interested in.
Right.
And then as far as Irredeemable, that is an interesting idea, but I don't know. I don't know.
You know, the funny thing about Irredeemable was at the very end of it, there was a case for redemption.
Spoilers.
And they do it in such a way that connects to like the real world. It's meta and it's just fantastic.
Dude, that comic book is like 20 years old by now.
Is it that old? Irredeemable.
Point. If you can't yell spoilers because something's 20 years old.
No. It's so good.
No spoiler talk anymore. Pass the thing. But you know what though? All right. Here you go, guys. This is fun talk. All right. How about this? Top 5 books, comics. Desert Island Experience. What are your picks? You can only pick 5.
Lone Star, 1.
I was waiting for Mike to say that, but nice.
Monster Hunt 1 and 2.
Doom Kicker.
Wait, which cover? I'm just kidding.
Mike's cover.
Oh, dang.
First one.
I like the way this is going.
Not your own projects.
My 5 top comics are probably Planetary.
Oh, that's a good pick.
I want to say X-Men, but I have to specify like what era. Good point.
point, so don't waste my time. What else?
X-Men.
I'm such a jerk. Don't waste my time.
I'm trying to think what else. I mean, those are the two that like pop immediately into my head. Dark Knight Returns. The four issues, Frank Miller's series. The three.
Okay. All right. I like that so far.
Watchmen. I'll put Watchmen in there. I thought that was very good.
Okay. Whatever.
And
gosh, Jiminy, you can't come to my house
anymore. Fantastic Four.
Fantastic Four. That's an interesting.
That's so unspecific.
Okay, John Byrne's Fantastic Four.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah, that works.
Remember when he burned that kid alive?
Oh, that was awesome. He wrote such great stories how long did you do it? Like 80 issues or something?
No, I used that argument, that story against him in an argument because he's an atheist.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he's like using the why would God allow bad things to happen to his creation story. Uh-huh. I'm like, you burned a kid alive in your story. No. I'm like, why would you, as the god of your comic, burn your characters alive? He's like, well, you know, just tell the story. Just make a point. Make a point.
Oh, man.
Yeah, exactly.
Right, and was it right after that that he suggested he name his letter column burn victims?
No, I did that a lot of years before.
Speaking of which, you should name your mail column burn victims.
All right. How about you, Michael?
Avengers Forever.
Avengers Forever. Okay. Yeah, okay.
Aerosmith.
Aerosmith.
Okay. All right. Okay. These are interesting ones because... they're pretty obscure.
What?
Come on, Michael.
Forever was epic. Talking about.
It might be epic to you, but they're not. I mean, I've
never heard of it.
Just saying.
What?
Aerosmith?
Yeah.
What is that?
Kurt Busiek and Carlos Pacheco?
No.
Who are those guys?
So far, I see a pattern in terms of the book you like, but yeah. I've not heard of that particular book.
That's right. You got it. You got the pattern.
Yes, I got the pattern. Those books.
Yeah, the Marvel X-Men Essentials, John Byrne, Clarice Claremont run on X-Men.
Okay, cool.
That's cool.
And yeah, I'd probably go with the John Byrne Essentials run on Fantastic Four too.
Yeah, this is a great book.
Bottom line, dude, John Byrne knows comics.
Okay, Mecca, how about you?
If he's an ass.
Well, I said Irredeemable.
Oh, yeah.
I
read
that thing 100 times. Then I'd probably go to, I'd probably ask for like the entire manga of Naruto.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Yeah. Manga. Oh, no. Dumpster fire.
What? I don't care. I love manga.
Dumpster fire.
Okay. And then Spider-Man.
Naruto was great. Love that book.
Dude, I don't know how many Spider-Mans I could take, but whenever I pick up a Spider-Man book, I usually have a good time. But I've been meaning to reread the Superior Spider-Man, I think it was.
Oh, yeah.
I really like that one. I don't know why.
Hmm.
Then
is that your five? Is that five? I can't.
Superior Spider-Man.
I fell asleep after your first one.
Yeah, I don't know. <love you. laughs>
I'm just kidding, man. I'm fine.
And then I'd probably pick up Jawbreakers because I would need something to keep warm at night, so I'd probably just burn those.
Whoa.
Oh, no.
Whoa. That was below the belt and unnecessary roughness.
No. I was thinking about it today, man. That dude makes me so mad these days.
Why? Who? Your boy Zach?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, like, he did the pandemic book.
Uh-huh. Right, yeah. How was that?
I don't know. People were still dying, and he's like, let me make a comic book about this.
Oh.
Come on, dude.
He's just striking while the iron's hot.
Yeah, I would just say don't write any more comic books. You're bad at it.
You know why he did that? Probably because as soon as that happened, all those freaking, like, you know, Breakout and Panda, all those movies.
That is true.
Swung to the top of the Netflix charts.
It's yeah, like, they did.
We all want to be entertained by what's happening by to the world right now. It's like
I don't know. That's just so bad. Like, people are starting to finally review the stuff, and it's just getting that Marge Simpson.
Homer.
Yeah, I'd probably take Jack Kirby's New Gods. Probably take that too.
Oh yeah.
Good man.
Not five yet, but Crisis on Infinite Earths.
Never got into that.
That was the first comic book I ever read, like, all the way through.
Really?
Like, when I was an adult and I can understand how to read, like, I was like, let me start with this. And then I remember I would get off shift, I would go to my room, and I would start reading it. And then it'd be like 1 a.m, I'd be like, oh, wait, I forgot to shower. Like, I need to go do something and get away from this. But I want to keep reading it. It's just so good.
I gotcha.
And it really was, like, infinite, you know?
Yeah, it was just too... Even now when I try to read it, I mean, it's just... It's too much. It's too
dense.
It's too dense. It's too much stuff crammed into it. And I'm just like...
For me, it's
like... It makes it more of a chore than fun for me to read.
Those are good choices, guys. You guys made some...
That's just
great. We got new jerks.
I think I would have to agree with New Gods, but I didn't think about it till you said it. But now that you said it, yeah, I gotta have Kirby. But is it? I'm torn between New Gods and Commandy because I really like Commandy a lot.
Oh, wow, huh?
I would also have to bring with me. That's one. I would bring Jazz Maynard. I would bring Batman Year One.
Ah, nice.
Yeah. Hellboy.
Huh? Anyway, what do you guys think so far?
I think it's looking really good. Nice flower blossom.
Quite nicely.
Very nice blossoming going on there.
Blossom? What?
Yeah, I like that.
What's this blossom? What is this blossom you're talking about?
It's nice. It's like looks like a nice bouquet of characters. Everybody's has some fun space. They're occupying different space and
yeah.
Very, very nice variety.
El Rodimus can recommend some comics for toilet paper.
I saw some of that there. We're gonna leave that alone for now.
Yeah.
What else? I got one more. I was thinking. Oh man. You know what? Oh yeah. You know what? I'm gonna have to go with. Oof.
I haven't heard any Hulk books.
Akira.
Oh, man. Oh, Elliot. Yes.
Well, see, the funny thing to me is I've never read the Akira manga.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but I know it's quite different.
Yeah, it is.
So I would take that one, too, if I had the chance.
It's breathtaking. Yeah. It's really good. Yeah, I don't. You know, it's funny because I love the. Here's my thing, right? I love the Hulk character, but I hardly read any Hulk comics when I was coming up. I started reading Hulk comics with Dale Keown, John Byrne and Peter David stuff.
Right. Yeah.
Was Dale Keown the one that gave him a machine gun?
That's when he was Smart Hulk. I didn't care for that too much, but I did like the look of Hulk in that time frame. But I've been a Hulk fan since I was a kid. From the TV show, I loved him in the cartoon, the 66 cartoon.
Yeah.
Apparently
Immortal Hulk takes a lot from the 60s TV show.
Yeah. So for me, I wasn't that I liked Hulk when he would make his appearances in other people's books. Like one of my favorite I have a Daredevil. What number is this? I forget. It's the one where Hulk is running around town and Daredevil can hear his heartbeat.
Yeah.
Whole city. And he's like, what is that? That pounding is this crazy. He's just like, he's super impressed at this sound. Like, I don't know what's going on. I've never heard something so powerful.
Right.
And he tracks it into this alley, and it's the Hulk. He's trying to rest. And I'm like, oh my God, the Hulk is so great. But so I've always been in love with the Hulk, but I found the comics to be boring. Like, but the when I did enjoy it, it was of certain issues, there's one in particular with Rom the Space Knight on the cover, and the Hulk's gonna throw a boulder at him by Sienkiewicz. I love that issue. That's with the Old Man Hulk, but it's because of the show, because it tied at the time when it came out. It was right around the time of that episode where the Halloween episode where Banner meets the Old Man Hulk on the Bill Bixby. The guy in that one. Anyway, they're all when he meets that guy in the town. But yeah, so
you haven't checked out the Immortal Hulk run?
I haven't yet.
Because apparently that takes a lot of inspiration from the TV show. Like, yeah. Apparently the Hulk only comes out at night, which was kind of a TV show thing.
I just don't trust comics, the big two companies anymore with my favorite characters.
You might get a kick out of that one.
Yeah,
I had a good time reading it.
I would have included
like the first 10 issues though. So,
but I like your guys' choices too. I love the idea of Burns FF. I love Birds X Men. Those are important books in my coming up. But I gotta say though that you know what, I missed a chance. If I could have one more, if I was going to one honorable
mention. Yeah, sorry.
Honorable mention would have been Bone. I would have brought Bone with me.
Oh, Bone. Yeah. That was a good book.
I love Bone. That's a big deal, too. I also love Hergé's Tintin.
Yes.
I genuinely enjoy
that. That's good. I have a few of those volumes. They're good.
So, yeah, but those ones I called out, like, I'm in love with is it Mazzucchelli or Mazzucchelli?
I think it's Mazzucchelli.
Yeah, I love Mazzucchelli's work. And I love how it's Toth.
I might throw the Sandman collection in there.
Sandman, huh? But now you got to leave one of your children behind. If you put any more books, you got to leave a child behind.
I don't think I picked five.
No?
I get Sandman.
If you had to pick one, which would it be?
Oh, dude. I don't know. I haven't read him so long.
One book. Which one book would you bring?
Oh, which one book? If I had to pick one book?
Mm-hmm. It's gonna come from that set or no?
I'm gonna go for Avengers Forever.
Avengers Forever, okay. I know what kind of man you are. Not much of one. I'm just kidding. I just want to be funny. Mecca, just one.
Oh, Irredeemable, hands down.
Irredeemable, lame. Jiminy.
One book?
Just one book.
When you say one, like not one issue, one series.
One series, yeah.
Wait, what series?
Well, I mean, some books are like Irredeemable is a series.
Yeah. It's
like 36 issues.
Yeah, it works.
One series.
You don't have enough room. You gotta leave a child behind if you bring too much, Michael.
I don't know.
I think if I was to be trapped on a desert island, I would leave a child behind. I would allow my children to live here while I'm forced to leave.
No, the world's in shambles, post-apocalypse. You don't have any more time for that nonsense.
Yeah.
One series.
You gotta be, this is the hardcore questions in life. Which comic? That's stupid, right? Not the Bible? How dare you?
I'll say
not a comic. Well, okay. The Bible. Well, yeah.
The Illustrated Bible.
I'll say The Nail.
Ooh, Alan Davis. I like that. Oh, it's my goodness. Short, good.
It's very short.
But it wasn't in your list in the first place, though.
Yeah, I know. But then I started thinking, like, who's my favorite artist? And then he immediately came to mind. Then I thought, he's also one of my favorite writers. So I started going through all of his books in my head. I mean, everything he's written and drawn, I've loved. I love The Nail. I loved Fantastic Four: The End. I thought that was fantastic.
Yeah, that was good.
I mean, there's. I mean, he's probably one of the most underestimated, underrated writer artist out there.
Dude, do you remember his run of X-Men with did that guy come back for that to write it? What's his name?
Who, Claremont?
Claremont, was it a Claremont series? Remember when it was right after he did the Fantastic Four run? This is like early aughts, and he started doing this X-Men, and then he opens up with the classic baseball game.
Dude, all right.
He killed that book, man. That book was awesome, man. I was like, I had almost forgotten about X-Men by that. He just brought me right back.
Yeah, he's just a phenomenal creator. Anytime he does something, I just run in to get it. I remember his series, what was it, Clandestine?
Oh yeah, I remember that.
He did back in the 90s. And he did a miniseries, and then he did more of an extended series. I think it only lasted maybe like 13 issues or something. But it was just really, really well done with a bunch of British superheroes all from the same family, except they weren't superheroes. They were just like a family with superpowers.
Yeah, yeah.
And just great stuff.
See, my problem with that early stuff, including his Excalibur work, he wasn't quite as refined, and some of his character designs were a little grotesque to me.
Uh-huh.
On X-Men, Farmer was inking him, wasn't he?
Yes. On the last run, that one final run. Yeah.
That's the run where he drew the X-Man that I designed. That was one of the highlights of my career, is having Alan Davis draw my design.
Oh, that's cool.
Oh, wow.
That's so cool. Now, dude, I Davis was a big deal to me. His stuff on the Nail. And do you remember his Superboy and the Legion?
Yes, I love that.
That thing was dope, man. That was one of his best works. Yep. I even liked his Kill Raven. I thought that was good.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
But I think he's one of those guys that he hasn't lost touch. He's not like weaker necessarily, but he's looser.
Right.
And it's not as strong when I've seen
him. Right. It's Farmer.
It must be Farmer, but then I've seen other stuff. But
I've seen his pencils though, and his pencils. I mean, yeah, I understand what you're saying. I mean, I think he's just older. You know,
it might be him. Might be
suffering. He's in his 60s now.
Wow. Yeah, so, I missed him at Heroes one year. He was there. Yeah. I didn't get to see him.
I met him. He had my badge on.
I remember the story. Yeah.
Every time I say something, Mike has to one up me.
Well, I'm just saying.
I had dinner with him once. I saved his life once.
It seemed like the opportune moment to one up.
He bought me dinner. He liked me better.
Yeah. He asked me to be his protege, but I was busy that week.
That's funny. No, that's cool. I love those kinds of stories. Yeah, I think if I had the one book, I think it would still be Hellboy for me. I think that the problem that he faces as like his destiny versus trying to be better than that, I think that's an important thing to me. But but yeah, I do appreciate those other suggestions. What else is good too? Alan Davis, man. Yeah, that I have the pencil, the I don't know what you would call it, the pencil edition of the Fantastic Four: The End.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I don't know how I got it. It was one of those times that I was like it was available, and I grabbed it off the shelf. Like, yes, I got that, and it's nice to look at in that format.
Yeah.
What else was he really? Was he was notable in?
I mean, he did Wolverine. They reissued a new book. This is probably a decade ago. He's done a ton of stuff.
That was the Amazing Wolverine, something like that. It was right. It was right after Joe Madureira did his part of that. Yeah. I didn't like. So here's the thing with him. There's something he does weird with the noses. They flare a lot, and it works well on Batman, especially that one shot in the Nail where Batman's falling off the roof while about to murder Joker. That was on my. I had photocopied it. I had it on my wall at my job. I love that thing. I was like, that is Batman all day.
Yeah.
But his Wolverine, though, I wasn't that interested in it. He draws him with a weird white nose.
And I like that, though, because it makes him seem more animalistic to me.
That's true. Yeah, it does seem more bestial that way, but I just don't, you know, it's just, I like him being more, I like Wolverine sleek. It's like Batman. I like him sleek. Yeah, I like when Wolverine has, like, when the mask isn't flaring as much.
The mask.
He's a little more aerodynamic. I like he looks. I like him hunched over all the time. I mean, the only other time I like him like that is when he was how they rendered him in the Marvel, X-Men Children of the Atom game, and all the other subsequent games.
Capcom Sprite.
Yeah, that was another great stuff. But
Berserker Barrage.
But Davis taught me a lot. I learned a lot because I always felt like if Neil Adams and John Buscema had a baby, it was Alan Davis.
Yeah, and to me, it's like Alan Davis is in that lineage that produced Carlos Pacheco.
That's interesting you say that. I feel like Pacheco's more of a son of Hughes.
What?
Yeah, yeah. I see a lot of.
I see Alan Davis styling and Buscema like storytelling.
Yeah, but Pacheco's a little stiffer than Davis. So is Hughes, but Hughes is actually much nicer now. Like he does a good job of a lot of his stuff now in that way. But no, I see what you're saying. When I in my collection of stuff, Pacheco fits into the same box with
Pacheco in a box.
I feel like he's a prototype for Stuart Immonen, but Stuart Immonen was really a clone of Hughes early on. That's why I make those kinds of comments. I think Pacheco before Hughes?
No, I don't think so.
Hughes has been around since the 80s.
Yeah, Hughes has been around a long time.
Yeah, yeah. There's something about Pacheco's form that I really love. He does a good like Alex Ross Regal thing that I try to do with like the upshot. I love his upshots. Like whenever he draws Superman, he's always super regal and powerful and posing. You know, he's just like King.
Pacheco always reminds me of, or maybe the other guy reminds me of Pacheco. Joe Madureira. Is that his name? They always seem to have similar sort of manga
shapes,
influenced, like in your face styles.
I can kind of see that.
Posing and stuff.
Yeah.
That's what I like, the dynamism of his poses.
Mm-hmm.
Just stuff that I never saw before, you know.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's hard to do something that's iconic and new at the same time.
Aerosmith is a good book if you get a chance to check it out, Jimmy.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to look that up. I've never heard of it. And it's written by it's with Carlos Pacheco and who's the writer?
Kurt Busiek.
Okay.
Yeah, that's funny because Busiek also wrote Avengers Forever, right?
I believe so. Yeah.
Yeah. That's interesting, Michael. You're a music guy.
I don't like him personally, but
he's a comic person.
Dude, there's some guys that just get comic books, you know, Mark Waid, Kurt Busiek, John Byrne. It doesn't mean they're, you know, I'm not going to agree with them on everything, but if they know how to write comics, they know how to write heroes. Damn, dude. That's the craft.
That's all I care about.
Great American art form.
Yeah, that's right.
I almost included CC Beck's Shazam in my collection.
Yes.
He's
Monster one of Society.
Two. Huh?
Monster Society.
Yeah, yeah. I love that character so much.
Yeah.
And it's one of the ones that got me wanting to produce anything at all in the first place was my affection for Shazam.
Hmm.
Or Captain Marvel.
She's like him.
That's my mom's favorite character when she was a kid.
I love Superman for some of the same reasons, but
mm-hmm.
the element of the child, like the child becoming a man,
Right.
That power fantasy there is very charming.
Yeah.
But I had a character I was developing at one point where I wanted to go the other way. I wanted to make an old man become the child.
Ah.
Where something happened where he gets to relive his life again.
Uh-huh.
And correct the mistakes he made in his life. And I thought that was an interesting way to kind of tell that story.
Yeah.
Oh, you might like Shadow of the Conqueror.
Yep.
Who? What's
that? The book I just finished today.
Oh, you finished it?
Yep.
That sounds a lot like the pitch Mike had the other night.
Cool.
Oh, I didn't hear it quite that way. All right, cool. Yeah, I just like the idea of that.
Yep, this old van was basically stolen.
What's it, my van was stolen? I don't have a van, Michael.
Stalin?
Isn't he a bad guy from Russia?
Yeah.
Yeah, but this book is like, what if Stalin had an extra chance as a young man?
Oh, I got you.
Quentin, you know. Yeah, this old guy, and then he turns into like 15 years old, and he's got a chance to do right.
My problem was when I started thinking that it would be cool to have a love interest, all I could think about was how creepy was this old man in a young boy's body. Like, that's weird. So I said, no.
That reminds me of Ultimate Wolverine. He did a body swap with Peter Parker at one point, and then when they switch back, Mary Jane tells Peter, can we wait on the adult stuff till later? That was really weird. And then Peter's like, what did you do in my body?
That's weird. That is weird. Look at you.
Very weird. I feel weird for even bringing it up.
I'm uncomfortable right now. Michael, have him removed.
Yeah, check out Shadow of the Conqueror by this little-known artist named Mike Miller. He's done like a couple of things. Link should be in the chat.
Yeah, drop that link in the chat for Shadow of the Conqueror, everybody, if you are not already signed up to the mailing list. Also, LoneStarComic.com will take you to the mailing list for Lone Star 3, which I'll probably also be using for Monster Hunt 2. So, get on up.
Well, it's Damon or whatever. He's like 80, and then he jumps off the cliff, and he becomes like 15 or something.
Yeah, like 17.
Yeah.
Yep.
Does he have a love interest?
Spoilers. No.
All right, Mecca.
No, he doesn't have a love interest.
Is Mecca a Cowboy Bebop fan?
Yes.
Ugh. Okay. Just kidding.
Whatever you're drawing there is fantastic.
Does this look like him? Does this look like Spike?
Let me see. Spike? Yep. Definitely. Especially with the cigarette.
Yeah. Maybe his chin might have a little too much chin, but other than that, looks good.
Really? Really? This is, I'm drawing it my way.
He could cut glass.
Good.
Well, which is it? Is it good or you just don't like it?
No, it's good. It looks like you could chin butt somebody.
Why don't you just shut me up and call me a jelly donut?
One of my best friends in baseball.
Elliot, if it makes you feel any better, I think it looks like trash.
There you go.
Michael, thank you.
You're welcome.
Jerk. You can't out-jerk the jerk monger.
Hey, Muerte's here. What's up,
Muerte? Muerte!
All right. Okay.
That's fantastic.
Mel, kiss my grits.
Well, Mike, it's 3 o'clock in the morning where I am, and I have to get to bed.
Quitter.
I'm sorry.
You know what?
Quitter.
That's no excuse.
Winners never win. Winners never quit, Jenny.
But thank you very much for having me on.
You got it, bro.
It was a pleasure and an honor. It was great talking to you guys. And folks, have a great night.
You too.
See ya, Jiminy.
You guys take care.
I like talking about comics from the old days.
Yeah, comics are fun.
Muerte, what's up? Doom, 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 doom. Doom, 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 doom.
I was just saying that I like having a channel where people talk about comics and art.
I was doing a show on my channel for a while. We did 6 episodes of just straight comic appreciation. Called it the Spinner Rack. We had a good time doing it.
Nice.
We all just brought our favorite issue, a couple screenshots in the Twitter thread. It was a good time. Yeah, 6 hours of comic content that I think even the bigger comic YouTubers can't compare to. It's nice holding.
Bigger, that. Like fatter?
Froggier.
My mother what?
I'm a Spectre says what?
Hey, I guess Anna's doing some The Boys stuff over there with Dynamite.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Good for her. Good for her.
And Charlie's London launched today.
Yeah, that did pretty well.
First time book, 22 grand last I checked.
I'm happy for her. I was surprised.
I just can't imagine ever wanting to read a comic book about Charlie Chaplin.
Yeah.
But more power to her.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not the audience, so I'm always surprised when... I mean, I shouldn't be. I'm not a fan of everything, and if there's people out there that are fans of stuff, then obviously, you know, there's a fan base.
Yeah, there's a market for everything, I guess.
Yeah. I mean, it's the same thing with the cat book. It looks great and everything.
But, I mean, half of the internet is cat humor, you know?
Yeah, I guess.
And that book looks fantastic.
Yeah, it's really well done. Just not my shtick, you know? Personally. I
love cats. Man, I was surprised his Draw Your Cat into the Book tier was so expensive, though.
You know what? It needs to be expensive. Can you imagine trying to draw a cat for someone and you get it wrong? And
you got to study cat anatomy.
Like that. Well, that doesn't look like Fluffy. Like, well, I'm sorry. What does Fluffy look like? It looks like this. Oh, that's what I drew. No, it doesn't. You didn't get the nuance. I'm like, oh, God.
He'd never smile.
Fluffy, right.
Yeah.
I remember, I've done some not caricatures, but just kind of pseudo caricature, kind of portrait stuff. One time, it's all like children is always hard to do because they don't have any distinguishing features yet, like babies and stuff. They kind of all look the same in my head.
Jeez, that's what my dad used to say.
What?
That's what my dad used to say.
What do you say?
That babies all look the same.
Yeah. I think they look like, I used to tell my wife, it looks like a lizard. She's like, don't say that. Like, it looks like a lizard. Got lizard eyes and just saying. Sheesh. You're not nice. I'm sorry. I believe in lizard people. Okay.
So do you believe?
Do you believe in life after lizards?
You know, that was one of the first mainstream pop songs to have auto-tune in it.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, that's right. When
I lived in Korea, I used to go to the Juicy Bars and...
Whoa. That sounds not right.
What?
They were Juicy Bars. You know, you'd go buy a girl a juice.
Mm.
For her time. And I'd go there with my buddy and I'd request Believe in Life After Love every time. And then I'd walk in and they'd just start playing it for me. It was weird.
You're something else.
Yeah. I was going to make that into a good story and I started feeling weird about it halfway.
You know what you should do? Tell that story in comic form.
Ooh. Every panel's a moment in time.
All right. So far, I'm liking it. Liking it. It's good now.
We're coming up to a crowdfunding bubble pop pretty soon.
Why?
I think it's a bubble. It's going to pop. There's just so many smaller projects out there. lot of fatigue.
Do you mean funding in general, or do you mean
for the comic scene?
Group in the comic scene, because
anti-SJW politically minded stuff, you know. Like, look at your boy Zach. His latest graphic novel has the least amount of backers ever.
Well, they're not just going to back anything.
That's what your boy is finding out, I think.
Yeah. Well, it's like I said, man. Some stuff you're going to think is going to find an audience. And
then you come up with the cat Power Rangers. And all of a sudden, there's
not. Apparently that works, but not for me.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. There's an audience out there for most things. It's just you got also got to be there where they are, and
you got to come to them a little bit, you know.
Something like that. I don't know. I don't know specifically what he's been working on, so. But
he had this one about escaping the planet when the pandemic was caused by aliens. I thought the idea of doing a pandemic book was kind of weird. And then doing a book where the aliens caused it and enforced it is just
strange. Well, they enforced the quarantine.
Yeah. I don't think that's going to turn out very good.
That's all about execution. So.
Yeah. I don't know. Just seems way too topical for me.
Well, I think a lot of things can work in a lot of ways. I think there's always room for anything at this point.
Yeah.
And I think that's not necessarily against what you're saying, but it's more of a, if we're not careful, we're just talking about, what we're really saying is that there's a lot of things that we're just different about these days, you know? And to that point, I would say,
duh.
Yeah. Because there's a lot of things to think about. You got to also think about the demographics on the platforms you're using. That might have worked better on Kickstarter, for example. The cat thing. I don't know. Was it successful?
Yeah.
Oh, well, then what are we talking about? I mean, he sold it.
I'm just saying it's not something that I would have, but you know, Mecca, when we were talking about before, he's like, no, that'll do well. And I'm like,
oh yeah.
Okay. I'm not, you know,
we bet something on that, didn't we?
I don't remember.
Why is it? Yeah, we got a commission, right?
No, I don't think so.
Yeah. I think a lot of stuff you got to keep hammering away. I don't know that there's a bubble. I think.
Well, maybe not a bubble, but I think the smaller projects are going to start dying off pretty quick.
Well, here's why I don't think it's a bubble, because I don't think it's an industry the way we know it. It's you're kind of your own little industry. You're finding your group, and they're going to support you more or less on the things that they like or don't like. If you try to make it like, oh, we're just a big unit of like a big group of things, that might fade out, because people are going to be like, well, not everything that group makes is great.
Mm.
But if you're solid with your audience and they enjoy what you do, why not? You know,
that's a good point.
And I'm not just saying that to try to like, oh, well, come on. It's got to last long enough. No, it's just.
Calliope says, your boy Zach was talking about his idea for Forbidden Stars way back when he was Diversity in Comics and he was doing his live streams. I bought it.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. And timing is another thing. You know, maybe some ideas didn't work because it wasn't something, you know. There's I don't want to buy the Jesus is Crucified comic. It's like I saw the Passion, for example, the movie. I saw the Passion of the Christ, but I can't go. Hey guys, what we watch this week? Let's watch the Passion. Get the popcorn. That doesn't work for me. You know, the subject matter is too important. It's too heavy and deep. So
yeah.
when this, maybe that's why, if it was because of the pandemic and whatever, maybe it was just the wrong timing for it, you know, if it wasn't as successful as it could have been or something. But there's a lot of factors. I don't know. I wouldn't count this out, because this is going to be, I think, the way it's going to go from now on. If anything's going to come out, it's going to come out like this. And I think it's good. I think it, even if you're right and it's not as strong,
it's then we sad. Can bet a commission.
Huh?
Then we can bet a commission.
I don't care about it that way. I'm just saying that it would be sad if it didn't work out, because it's not of a desperation thing. It's just, it's a cool way to get your stories out there.
It is.
And get content created, you know? There's always the evil digital nobody wants to talk about, but I like digital.
Yeah, but I don't want the entire industry being forced to do digital.
It's not going to be a force. It's going to be a natural sway of the market. Why do you hate free market, Mike?
That's being forced.
Bernie Sanders here. I mean, you don't need 23 armpit smells or deodorants. You don't need 23 deodorants.
What are you talking about?
According to Bernie Sanders.
Oh.
They are complaining about lines for food. I think lines for food is a good thing.
I think I'm doing this wrong. I'm trying to draw the head from the goggles. That's the wrong idea. Let me start over.
I'm really, really curious to see how good Shadow of the Conqueror turns out, Mike. Really banking on this one.
It's going to turn out really well.
I know. I'm just thinking, are we talking thousands or?
Well, you mean how's it going to sell?
Yeah.
I'm curious as well. We've got quite an email list already. I'm not going to say how many. But
I'm mostly curious because Shad Brooks is, for him, he's going from prose to comic.
Mm-hmm.
So how many customers do you lose or gain in that?
Because
the golden number is 30,000 books.
A good question.
How many of those 30,000 book buyers can we turn into comic buyers? And by we, I mean you and him.
How many who wouldn't buy the comic or who wouldn't buy the book are going to buy the comic?
Yeah.
Let's see where we're at on.
Are you guys using verbal gymnastics on me? I don't know what the hell you guys are talking about. You just confused me. I was with you.
Honestly, you know, the way you talk about the story, it's very comic book. Very comic booky, like,
yeah, it's very superhero in a sort of 16th century setting.
Hero's journey,
something like that, like a 16th century
supernatural elements to it,
steampunk, but like alternate fuel source. You know, that nothing runs on steam. There's light stones and there's dark stones. And so they allow for different like locomotion and energy sources and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So it's kind of science fictiony, fantasy / superhero. I don't know. It's a lot of stuff. It's a lot. It's a very interesting combination of ideas.
So this might be something people make fun of me for down the road, but I think this could be the biggest crowdfunded comic of anyone we've seen in our circle, at least.
Well,
it could be.
It will. Oh, darn it. Did I do this in the wrong layer?
Like, I'll be really surprised if this isn't comparable to Earthworm Jim 1.
I did this on the wrong
layer. Cyberfrog.
Dadgummit, I did it on the wrong layer. I will be very happy if it is. Gee. X. I do think it has the potential to be, but I you know, I can't. Who can say?
Guess we'll see.
Mecca just did.
Thank you.
I'm willing to bet it's comparable.
To which?
To Earthworm Jim 1 at the very least.
Well, we're 2 days into launch, and we've got, you know, here, I'll just show you guys in the private chat how many. It's not my thing, so I don't want to.
Is it actually launched?
No. We've got the pre-launch page up.
And we've gotcha. Got, I was going to say, you launched it? Whoa.
If you want to look at that number, that's how many people we've got signed up for the mailing list already on day 2. In the chat.
Oh wow. Not shabby.
Not shabby.
Not shabby at all.
Now what's the rate of those at that number? I wonder how many actually end up buying.
I don't know. But that's obviously the number that are interested thus far. And we're not gonna drag this out. You know, we're gonna launch in November, so hopefully they're still interested in a couple few weeks. Yeah, he mentioned it. Oh, here, let me just show you. Let's go to one of his latest video. I really did like. Oh, let me just look it up. Shadiversity. Shadiversity. All right. Stop screen. Share screen. So you see on this latest video. 67,000 views. And it's here. This is what I wanted to do.
You know, I'm making a graphic novel of my book Shadow of the Conqueror with one of the best comic book artists in the industry, Mike S. Miller.
That's right.
You'll be able to skew your copy when the launch campaign goes live in November, but sign up now on Indiegogo so you don't miss out on any of the limited edition special goodies that will be available, as well as the graphic novel itself, which is only going to be available for a short time during the launch campaign. I swear by the name of God and the Holy Mother that you...
All right, anyways. And then down here in the show more, he's got the link to the pre-launch page and my YouTube channel. So actually, I've seen a nice little uptick in the last 2 days of all subscribers. So 1,750 comments. Didn't really want to go through all these. On the other one, we had a couple of people who were being typical. What do you call those? CG cancel culture
people? Sucker MCs.
EBS JWs.
There you go. Yeah, we had a couple of those because, you know, can't just let Mike do something without trying to cancel him.
Well, they can't let him be more successful.
Sad.
But I've got a number of celebratory ideas, should that be the case.
Well, I had, if you might not see, but on one of my things, another YouTuber who, I don't know how many subs he has, but his videos usually get around 20, 30,000 views, just asked me, he's like, hey, are you available for more work? I'm like, email me. I'm like, I could probably hook you up with somebody. So,
Matt Weldon.
No, Matt's busy on my stuff.
Matt,
but no, look, man, if there's guys out there with good followings, that's my thing. I want to connect these audiences to comics. And so, if there's guys out there who want it to get done, and they don't know the first thing about you know, putting together a team and publishing and design, all the necessary stuff for that, freaking hit me up. I am perfectly willing to you know, connect you with good people. You know, good people produce good books. Because what I don't want, and I don't mean to, I'm not going to bag on anybody in particular, but what I don't want is for somebody to go through the time and effort and manage to convince somebody to buy a comic for the first time and they get sent some crap piece of junk that just turns them off from the hobby altogether. You know? If I'm going to, I'm happy to facilitate people into finding.
Mike, if you want me to leave and talk about me when I'm gone, that's fine. I can just leave right now.
Elliot, we'll talk later.
This guy puts out so much garbage.
So, but you know what I mean. I want people to get addicted from their first comic book experience.
Yeah, we don't want them getting, you know, like a Jawbreakers in their mailbox or something.
Well,
just kidding. I'm sorry.
What a spice, bro.
I know, right?
You know what? Today I decided I don't like your boy Zach too much. I'm sorry to the audience. Just saying. I don't know. Just woke up on the wrong side of the bed this morning.
Apparently.
Listen, man. That's between you and those people. I don't know what you're talking about.
Those people.
Yeah, see? You know, the problem was I got into a fight with a guy at the Burger King parking lot. That's why.
Yeah? Why'd that happen?
I just got some Burger King. I parked my car, and somebody said, you can't park there. And I asked, I politely asked the man for his identification. He pulls out a T-shirt. I go, that's not a badge. And he starts telling me he's going to get my car towed. My car had just been run into. And somebody broke out the window trying to steal it. And he said, your S is going to get towed. And I just, it was too much.
That was
it? I go, I don't know who you are, but you're obviously homeless and doing drugs in your car. So you should probably just leave me alone.
Wow. Wow. Straight for the juggler.
I mean, it was obvious.
I'm just saying.
You were in a spot.
I was at least four car lengths away, you know. They do that in this town. You know, they homeless people do drugs in parking lots. And then, I don't know, I just started associating that with your boy Zach.
What? What the hell?
I don't know. People waste my time, you know.
Man.
Interesting.
Listen, man, this is it's it happens, bro. It happens.
It happens.
Yeah, man, you got chill.
Whopper Lives Matter. The dude, Frankie Fat Hands. I wonder if you're talking about me. If that is for me, Frankie Fat Hands, I won't disagree with you.
No, I call you Fat Hands McGillicuddy.
McGillicuddy, man.
I love that name.
We've all been there. Thank you, Kung Fu Kitty. See, Jawbreakers is the room of content of comics, just less coherent. I think you nailed it, El Rodimus.
The room.
I did not hit her. I did not.
That's funny. I know that reference. I didn't get it at first, though. I was like, the room, that's a weird word. How would you use that? Oh, the movie. Gotcha.
I'm gonna get you, yes I am. I'm gonna get you, baby.
You know, I got in a fight at the movie theater too.
You know what? I'm seeing a pattern. I'm seeing a pattern. I think you're the common denominator.
Yeah. I think you're right. You're tearing me apart, jerkmonger.
I didn't mean to. How old are you?
33.
How old is this artist? I need to know. I'm ruthless today. You don't even understand. You walked into the jerkmonger thunderstorm, the whirlwind.
Oh well,
Ellie, you ready to bring the pain tomorrow night or what?
No, I'm not ready for that, but I will. I'm serious, though. I'm serious. I do think there should be like a questionnaire. Like, I want to know how old are you?
What are you trying to do?
Because I don't want to break a young person's, you know, spirit. Like, if they're trying, I just I just started. They don't know. They just want to talk to the famous Mike S. Miller, and Mike S. Miller is yelling at him like some drill sergeant. And it just brings me back to my days in basic.
Yes, sensei.
He said you love those days.
I do. I do. I love them.
All right, then I don't want to hear nothing about it.
But I'm a different kind of man, bro. I'm a jerk.
I'm going to whip these kids into shape. That's all I know.
Okay. Well, yeah.
They're going to go out there in the real world, and they're going to see the slings and arrows of real life editors, and they're going to thank me for saving their lives.
Well, you know, if somebody had just been a little easier on Hitler.
No. If someone had been a little harder on Hitler and he had learned his skill better,
he would have ruled the earth by now.
He could have been a happy artist on dogs. On
the conversations we get into on this channel.
Yeah, well, I walked into it.
Well, we're doing better than the Burger King homeless man. I'm just mostly ashamed to bring up Burger King and admit to eating it, but you know.
Are you sure he's homeless? Like maybe he has like a Maserati.
Why are you eating Burger King, dude? What the hell?
I don't know.
I like their burgers better than McDonald's.
I like their Rodeo burger.
All their food is trash.
It is trash.
It is.
All your trash are belong to us.
I'm gonna get you. Yes, I am.
McGillicuddy.
Isn't that a great word?
I hate placeholder figures.
What?
Well then, I need a character design here.
I'll do it, Mike. What do you want?
Why the heck did I expect him to get around to this?
Send me the specs. I'll figure it out.
I'm gonna look you, baby. I could just design it myself and then force him to use my design.
I'm gonna help you, Mike. Why don't you love me?
Will you have a pros pick for the critique night?
Pros pick? No.
Pick?
What? Yeah, like this was the best entry of the night?
No.
I think a lot of people would be gunning for that award.
I'm gonna give a grade to what I see.
Ooh, spicy.
Why? Why is that spicy? You're making me nervous. What's going on with this? Forget
spice
it.
Spice is the good part of life, you know?
No, I quit. That's it.
Spice is the spice of life.
That's right. Spice is the spice of life.
Don't be quoting Dune to me.
The spice.
The spice will flow. Stello Lurking Weldons. Thank you, this space for rent.
No? What's he doing? Sleeping?
I wish I was. I'm with Jiminy. It's already 3:30 for me.
You stay right there, mister.
I shall. Okay.
What you call my mama?
What you call my mama? So this dog, right? It's a corgi, right?
Yeah.
The Bebop show?
Yeah.
It's Ein.
I gotta draw a corgi. I've never really drawn a corgi.
Oh, goodness. Mr. Deadness Pocket said, if Hitler had become a good artist, he would have been twice as deadly.
That's what I was saying earlier.
Whoa. Like
me and Deadness Pocket.
Copacetic.
Yes, yes, y'all. What? Where is this dang corgi? I need a good... Okay, that's good. That's a good shot. Just need to figure out what the shape.
Hey, have you talked to Antonio about the Dame Drops thing?
We talked a little bit about it. Yeah. I designed the logo for the comic.
I think it's cool.
I think it is cool too, man. I'm excited for that. That's the same kind of thing you're talking about.
Yep.
See, I think that one doesn't have the potential as much as Shadow of the Conqueror. It's just that's a case where I think it shows how important the subject matter is to it, where, like I said earlier, Shadow the Conqueror has a lot of comic bookness already built into it. I'm wondering if Kanan and Antonio will be able to translate this Damon Drops project into, translate some of those uncomic book elements into it, rather.
Well, we don't know what it's about. Do you know what it's about, Elliot? Do you know anything?
A little bit about it, but I'll let Antonio talk a little more.
He's not here.
he becomes like a character. It's a little bit of comedy. I actually think it's a pretty cool idea in general. And you got to remember, listen, comic books are in a condition today because of the fans, partly. We either bought things or didn't buy things. So if you can get some new fans in there, I think that could be a good thing.
Yeah.
And if I actually think it's better if we always talk about, like you were just saying earlier, Mike, you know, all these poses are similar to things you've seen before. Maybe the comic booky thing is not what it needs. We just got to find some new ways to interpret storytelling.
I just want to find new people to get addicted to the story or the medium itself.
Well, and yeah.
If they get there through you know, five guys.
Yeah.
That's my favorite Damn Dolls video.
Damn.
Then more power to him, man. I'm all good with that. It's all fungible, you know. They're gonna find other stuff they're interested in, whether it's superheroes, whether it's cat comics, whether it's ghosts and things that go bump in the night, whatever it is. As long as they start getting addicted to to my art form, it's right. Good for all of us.
That's what I mean to say when I talk about that.
I just want to get people addicted. Mike Miller, 20.
That's right.
Yeah. Well, doesn't sound like it.
I want people to be afraid sound like it to how me. Much they love me.
That's what I think you're trying to say, and I think that's the wrong answer. I think you fail your test in life.
Are you talking to him, right?
Well, the shoe fits. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Guys. Gosh, you guys take me too seriously.
What's that word you guys talk about? Aspersions?
Cast your aspersions.
Yeah, I don't want to cast any aspersions, but...
Yeah, you do. No, you do it all night long, dude. That's all you do, is cast. Yeah. It's like you're a fly fisher with aspersions.
Well, I'll cast aspersions one more time.
What did you say?
I ain't buying no comic book about a hamburger.
I ain't buying no hamburger comic book.
That's right.
Off no banana tailpipe.
I pretended to be a hamburger for a year. I'm not reading a comic book about it.
Then that comic book's not for you. That's the thing. It's not for you. It's okay.
That's right. It is okay. And I hope they're successful. Because like Mike says, we got more comic book readers coming in.
Well, I'll make sure they stay away from you, though. Because I think that you're going to make them cry.
Oh, Antonio's blocked me already. I don't care.
Who's running it? Is Antonio running it, or is Dame Drops running it? And
I don't know for sure. I don't know. I'm not clear on all that.
Because I want to use like the mailing lists to be promoting each other. It's like it doesn't have to be like a mail about us, but at the bottom of our mailing list, if we're like, you know, here's other comics by cool creators, you might want to check them out. That kind of stuff. You know. And then we could do it to each other.
Cast aspersions on that idea, but that's a really good idea.
I'm going to cast aspersions on your traps.
Listen here.
Take those traps and you do something with them.
I tweeted today, I go, don't like this tweet unless you have better traps than me. And you know what? I still got a couple jokers liking that tweet. A couple liars.
You know what? Better traps is subjective.
False.
No.
We can measure.
No, you're saying larger traps. That's not the same thing.
Better is larger.
No, that's your subjective opinion.
Me, 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 me.
Everything Mecca says is subjective opinion. What are you talking
that's
about?
True. And none of my opinions are good.
He's a subjective subjector.
You see what I'm drawing, Elliot?
Yeah, I love it. It's a little baby T-Rex.
Love. Oh, Mike, you got to see this comment here. It's a good one.
6 years ago, I read all the Game of Thrones books, then ordered this Hedge Knight book thinking they were novels. It said it was books.
Mike did the art. It was the books Mike did the art. I became obsessed with comics after. That's exactly my goal in life, Juke Joint, is to bring people like you into my hobby and get them addicted.
Mr. Juke Joint, haven't seen you around these parts. How did you find?
He was staying away
Reckless from this universe.
He was staying away from you. But he couldn't resist. He had to jump in. He had to.
Oh, he's one of yours?
No, I'm claiming him though.
No, he's mine. He just said it.
Huh? What?
He just said it right there.
Oh, is that what he meant?
I'm My sorry. Art got him addicted to the art form.
You don't have to keep reading it. I get you.
Gosh. Wait, 6 years ago, I read all the Game of Thrones books. My mother ordered his Hedge Knight books, thinking they were novels. Hey, do you have the Mystery Knight Juke Joint? Go ahead. Keep going. Now I'm obsessed with them and been teaching myself to draw last 2 years. Love the creation
process.
Yeah. Process. Tyler from Draw and Talk is a buddy of mine, and Brad Ashworth. Oh, right on. Cool.
Sweet.
Brad was in here just earlier. But yeah, man, that's, I love to hear that. I thank you for posting it, man. That's like legit my dream come true when people say stuff like that.
Hey, Mike.
Yes.
6 years ago. I couldn't even get it out.
He couldn't even start it.
I just want you to feel better.
It'll work.
Well, I'm very excited.
It wasn't nearly as graceful as that, I assure you. Oh, wait, Juke Joint's the guy that's missing fingers but can draw with it. Interesting.
Oh, nice. Oh,
that's a talent.
I mean, not nice that he's missing fingers, but nice that he can draw with it.
Nice that you overcame your challenges.
Your metacarpal disadvantage.
Yes. If you like Mike's art, check out mega7.com.
Those will be here on Monday.
And you can even see art drawn.
Sign up at lonestarcomic.com for my next superheroic epic tale. Shadiversity. The Shad book. I don't know if you're familiar with it. But the link should be in the chat from somebody. That's my next, what should be launching next, I think.
How's this corgi? Does it look corgi enough?
It's corgalicious.
Can you see it?
Yes.
That dog is a little sad looking.
That's what corgis look like.
Yeah, I'm kind of looking at one from the side. Yeah, well, I could.
My mom had a corgi.
If I could give you any constructive criticism, it'd be on the corgi.
By all means.
That'd be the only thing I'd have to say about it.
You got better?
Yeah. What? Mine's always like a little more clueless looking.
You have a corgi?
No, the cartoon, the anime.
See, this is the one thing.
Oh, Ein.
Yeah.
You said mine.
No, Ein. Yeah. It's a little off, but not by much.
Well, I'm trying to look. I'm looking at actual. I struggle a little bit more with dogs and stuff like that anyway. But
yeah.
It's okay. I'll figure it out. Maybe I got to do.
Yeah, we held a funeral for our corgi on my dining table.
You killed a corgi?
No, she died of old age.
Aw.
Cute little sucker. All corgis are cute little suckers. Unfortunately, they're purebred, so they don't have much of a time span on their inset dates. Blade Runner? No? Nobody? All right, that's fine.
No.
Blade Runner.
I haven't seen Blade Runner.
What? Shut up.
I haven't.
Shut up.
I'll say it again. I haven't.
Shut up right now.
I haven't.
You sound like Siege, Mike.
Oh, wow.
Shut your mouth.
Where is Siege? Did you invite her?
She's scared.
Think she's scared?
I'm just going to go with she's scared.
She's a bit chican. Like butter pecan, chican.
Your phone is not in here. I don't know. No, I'm not sure. I'm fairly sure, though.
All right, so now I'm going to light this puppy up. Here we go. Boom. So I'm going to add a little more black to this, but... Boom. Boom. Get rid of... Boom. I'm liking it. I'm liking it.
Yeah, I like it when you like do the different characters in different colors so you can set them apart when you're inking.
Yeah, well...
Blinking.
Probably won't do it that way in the I like making them just one color ultimately, but when I get it out, because I just needed to for the shape. I lost my shape here. I don't know.
The shape. Corgis can't swim. Yeah. She died of old age. That's the story he's sticking with. Hey, that was a very sad moment in my family's life. So we did what any good, faithful dog lovers would do. We took her corpse and dropped her off at the vet.
Holy moly.
Would you like to arrange a funeral for her? Just stick her in the thing where you burn her. Get out of here.
Wow.
You can throw away cats in the garbage cans.
I buried the cat. See, the corgi was way too much meat to bury in my yard. That would have just stunk the place up.
You just said meat?
Meat.
Meat.
So grotesque.
We're all meat, brother.
The other white meat.
That's why I bury the bodies at the beach. The sand is much easier to dig up.
Vic wants me to look at his YouTube icon, and it looks like two horseshoes.
Oh, that's good luck. What?
I keep thinking it's a woolly mammoth. Is there any superheroes named Mammoth?
There is in Robert Kirkman's Invincible.
There is?
Oh, is there?
Yeah.
Darn. I like that name.
That's all right. Nobody's read that.
They're doing a cartoon of that coming out soon.
I know, he's making a joke.
That was another one of those kind of like irredeemable style stories. What happens when Superman goes bad? I don't know, he probably does bad stuff.
That's correct.
Does bad things? Good people? Probably shouldn't do that. That's the dumb part of that story. It's like, well, what's the lesson anyone can get from Superman has a bad day? I don't know. Don't piss off Superman.
Yeah. You don't piss on Superman's Cheerios.
Yeah.
You don't tug on Superman's cape.
No.
You don't spit into the wind.
That's not a good thing to do?
No.
Okay, here. We got tonight.
That's a song.
We got tomorrow,
brother.
Something or other.
On Superman's cape. You don't spit into the wind.
How come this isn't working?
Someone put their horse down.
There we go.
Oh, yeah. Was that Lady Celtic Moon or who?
Kung Flu.
Kung Flu Kitty.
Yeah.
You spit into the wind. It's supposed to be the Kim Jong-gi cover. It'll change in a little bit. Wait, what?
Those two horseshoes are Kim Jong-gi.
And you don't mess around with Jim. Thank you, Kung Flu Kitty, for being the only one who knew what I was saying.
Superman never made any money saving the world from Solomon Grundy.
That you know of. Didn't you see Smallville? Superman can crush coal, lumps of coal, into perfectly cut diamonds.
Oh, yes, he can.
An amazing skill.
He Yes. Yes, it would be.
Doesn't have to hire a jeweler or anything. Just perfect.
Every kiss begins with Kal-El.
How did you afford college? Just went to the grocery store.
Diamond.
I bought some briquettes from the grocery store. Sold them to De Beers.
Don't buy diamonds, folks.
No.
Because you've got a friend in the diamond business.
With a warehouse full of diamonds that they won't release because it'll ruin the market.
You got a friend in me.
Zoom, 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 zoom.
What's that dude that did the suit place? You're going to like the way you look.
Men's Warehouse? You know what it is?
Yeah, Men's Warehouse.
You're going to like the way you look.
And if you guys are wondering why the conversation has turned the way it has, it is almost 1 a.m.
Woo, woo.
Don't blame us.
All right, I'm gonna.
Also, I'm getting into the. I'm getting close here to tightening this up.
And if anyone wants to blame me, I would like to remind you that if I wasn't here, most likely Mike would have put on Finger Five.
Ding 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 ding.
I don't know what that means.
Oh my gosh, seriously? We should put some Finger Five for you.
All right. I'm liking this. I'm liking it.
I failed you. It does sound better this late in the night.
You're getting used to it.
Yeah. Not as critical.
6700. Wow. Hello.
I'm not coming up with nearly as many aspersions.
Nick, you got so many aspersions.
I know. I got to take an aspersion when we get done.
You need to take an aspersion sensitivity course.
I wake up in the morning, I have my coffee, and I take my morning aspersion.
I feel like you guys aren't paying attention to the song.
I'm not. That would be correct.
I'm not sure what a ding 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 is, but it's getting under my skin. I'm here.
Like one of those sounds that you like forget to pay attention to, and then it comes back to you like 5 minutes later, and you realize that it's been annoying you the whole time. Yeah. It's like when a kid just like, "Hey, Dad, and you tune it out, and then it's like, "What?" And then you got to pay for therapy after that.
Or for their therapy.
Yeah. Because Joe Biden says he can get hormone pills.
Wow. Yowza, yowza, yowza. All right, all right, all right. Let's see. Okay, so.
Joe Bedenio.
I'm pretty happy with where.
Luigi.
Maybe you're not, but I am.
Luigi, why did you jump?
No, Mario, no, what are you doing? It's no bueno.
See, that's a. You should sing a Finger Five song in that voice.
Poor Luigi. Poor Mario.
You got to see that little cartoon. It's funny.
Can we play that, or would it get struck?
I don't know. You know, I might. He'll do anything once. Once.
Everybody gets one. Right, Peter?
Whatever happened to Joe Piscopo?
How come yeah, Spider-Man.
You can say whatever happened to Peter. That'd be a great. Everyone gets one. Right, Peter? Turns around and look for Peter. What happened to Peter?
He only got one.
Oh. Gotcha.
Bing, 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 bing. Ugh.
Yes! The Japanese invasion has invaded your skull.
Oh, no. I am talking from personal experience, Kitty.
That's not even cool, bro.
Huh?
You're still singing it.
I know. I love it.
No, don't do that.
I love it.
No, no.
It is the music of my childhood.
We need some aspersions, stat.
Yeah, quick, hurry.
Quick, asperse something.
Chat, disperse with me.
All right. Now I've got to draw the ship.
Das Schiepen?
What does this thing look like again? It's cool. I've seen it
before. Order phone number 6700. Hello.
You gotta be self-conscious about my corgi, Mecca.
I like your corgi.
Thank you, man.
It's just a little dour.
Someone who had a corgi in the family.
As someone who's seen Cowboy Bebop like 8 times.
You know what? Maybe it's because you weren't paying attention and you have to watch it over and over again.
The corgi was my favorite part.
Well,
of course.
I noticed that you didn't buy a corgi.
Yeah,
Cowboy Bebop.
I don't buy animals; I adopt them.
How about them?
Whatever. Animals? Why are you? Why are you so biased?
Why am I aspersing so much?
Biased. He's biased.
Mario, no, no, it's Mario.
Oh, look at him! Look at here! Huh? Boy, look at here! I really like this ship a lot.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
Well, well, well. Look at what we got here. All right, all right, all right.
Watch your profanity.
Ding, 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 ding. In the tarnation. Well, I think I'm going to turn in, guys.
But I'm so close.
Oh. I'm so sleepy. It's 4 a.m. for me.
I just got to finish this.
It's good karma.
Yeah.
The second you leave, I'll cast an aspersion on you.
When was the last time you actually left before 4 a.m?
I know, and I pay for it every day. I've been getting like 2-3 hours of sleep every day.
That's not good for you, Elliot.
I get it. Thank you. But I got to say, man, I mean, overall, this is coming out pretty cool, right? Look.
Yeah.
Thing. It's a cool little movie poster look there.
Dopeness.
I'm looking at that and I'm just hearing ba-dip, 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 boo.
I like the my goal was to have them all facing. I was thinking about jazz. How would I make jazz work in art?
About-
and that they're all kind of like facing different directions, except this dude. He's like, yo, what's up? He kind of looks like Mads Mikkelsen. And look, if Jiminy were here, I'd fix this stupid chin.
Don't ever listen to Jiminy.
That dude could chin butt somebody.
That guy has no conscience.
There you go. And then the corgi.
Ding, 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 ding.
Oh, don't do that.
Ding, 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 ding.
You're a bad monkey.
Ding, 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 ding.
Monkey. That was an unusual encounter.
I tried to memorize the Japanese for that, but it slips out of my head so quickly.
Well, no one's asking you for that. You'll be all right.
I'm going to start singing it every time I do my show. Yeah?
Yeah, you won't have a show.
You... What?
We will all cancel Mike.
That sounds like a dispersion to me.
Dispersion.
He's disperging.
Disperging out. That's a fun word.
I too am up too late.
I'm almost done. Just hang out with me for a few more minutes. You're not even watching.
I just don't want the people
Elliot to hear thing.
Ding, ding, ding.
I mean, Elliot.
What? You named a kid Elliot? Elliot.
What? What do you want from my life?
I was thinking about that scene from Step Brothers today.
Which one?
He's like, I used to pretend to be a T-Rex, and I'd walk around in the backyard like this. And then my dad came out and said, stop being a dinosaur and get a job. You could not film that today. Some SJW would cast an aspersion on it.
Oh, these aspersions.
I see what you did there.
There'd be a spurring all over that.
It's too much aspersing.
Yeah. Might have took it too far.
Telephone number 6700.
All right. Yeah, I got some good reference for the ship. I'll work on that when I'm coherent for tomorrow.
Oh, I didn't hear the rest of your rules, Elliot, for tomorrow.
Was that?
You had some rules for tomorrow?
Oh, yeah. I would like to. I'll probably have to do behind the scenes in the Discord, just ask questions from the people who submit it. Like, what's. I think it's important. Like, if you're going to draw, like, if you're doing something that's. What I don't want to do is just tell people to draw like me. That's right. That's not helpful because they may not want to draw like me, or that might not be what that's good for them. But if you were drawing, as conversation with Andy, if you were doing like South Park, if your goal was to do a South Park design, yeah, I'm not concerned about anatomy.
Yeah,
I also don't want to critique stuff that's unfinished.
Yeah,
I don't think that's fair either, because we get real nitpicky about something that's not even fully formed yet.
Yeah,
so I'll probably use words like pass, and you'll just know, that's the jerkmonger way of being nice at being mean. Pass.
Not worth my time, he says.
Nice meanness.
Yep.
So you're trying to play good cop and bad cop at the same time.
No, I'm just trying to save my energy. I'm waiting for the real stuff to come through and say, hey, this right here. Trash. Okay, now let's judge this. All right. Like the first one was solid because it was like taking all the way to color. You know, like, well. And then even then it's like, well, we could have, I probably would have talked about the color too. But that's not that's more subjective. I'm not trying to hurt people's feelings there. Everything else?
Hey, color theory is not subjective.
In that case, it wasn't colors that it wasn't bad because it was just flats. It could have used a little more texture in it, maybe to make it look a little more polished.
Look, I'm not ever interested in trying to critique somebody's style. You know, that's up to them. I'm only about the objective stuff that needs writing or wronging, you know. Needs writing. I'm not interested in the wronging.
But you know what I'll do is don't forget, Mike, I gotta try to what time are you planning on doing it?
Same about 9, I guess.
I'm planning on being here, but I'm seeing my parents tomorrow. That can get long. But definitely looking forward to this, like, just, you know, I there's no reason to be, you know, if it's not ready, it's not ready. That's all.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
Yeah, there's usually like 100 years of comic book experience, so. You know, a lot of time people put in there. Craft.
That's like, I never really cared for Kelly Jones's long arms. But, you know, he became like such a, that was his thing. So nobody really wanted to challenge it. And rightly so. Who am I to challenge him doing long arms? Maybe he likes long arms. Maybe that's what he does. Maybe when I draw the chins on my guys, they look like my chins.
Hey, Jim, Jim.
All right, here we go. Bam.
All right, yeah, let's see it.
Ding, 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 ding.
Oh, why is that still on?
That was great, dude.
Oh, there we go.
I'm glad you didn't interrupt the hen any more than you had to.
Oh, you mean this aside with the logo?
Yeah, yeah. Are you using the same logo from the last time?
I was thinking about it. Probably. And then I can actually shrink it up and put it places. But
yeah, I like it, man.
Let me turn this.
Looks very righteous.
People can get a better look. See and see what people are saying, thinking.
That's a fun cover.
Thank you. Much more fun than the last one.
Right. I always think team ups are cool, especially big ones like this.
The guy from WebBank says, "Now I'm curious who's in the comic." That is amazeballs, as the kids say. What is this? This is Monster Hunt 2. Let's get cracking. Starring at Lone Star, some of his people. Nova. Not Nova.
Badger?
Nexus.
Nexus.
Nexus and Bigfoot Bill. And there are a spattering of their people in the comic as well.
You know what'd be cool?
Hmm.
If you do one of those silhouetted things where you put the numbers and you add this is this person, this person, this person. Little checklist.
Yeah. And then the giant bad guy in the background is Gormando, who is the giant bad guy in the story. Who is also the giant bad guy in the upcoming Nexus book, Gormando. Or the upcoming Nexus series, Gormando.
I think it looks great, man.
Yeah, that's a lot of fun right there.
Much better than my first attempt.
They don't do comic book covers like this anymore.
I don't know if I'm set with Bigfoot Bill's face.
It's a little intense.
Huh?
It's a little intense, yeah.
Intense?
You really emphasize the unibrow.
Well, he's got a unibrow.
Yeah. As someone who's been made fun of for a unibrow, I take it back.
Zoom in on his face real quick. You know what I think it is? Oh, that's why. Oh, I kind of like it. Yeah. Just right now, from farther away, the lines you use for the hair on his nose.
Uh-huh. It all just brightens up into...
Huh?
It just makes it look dark, like a weird nose shape.
Yeah, it's creating a weird situation there.
Let's compare the first cover.
What first cover? Oh, that one. You should use that as extra art in the book. Pin up or something. I like it.
Yeah.
I love Nexus in that. It was great.
Thank you.
I keep thinking Space Ghost whenever I see him.
Space Ghost! The bad guy is heartily interested in good food and drink. Oh, Gormando.
I get it. Keep thinking Chef Boyardee.
Yeah, man. I don't know how long this is going to take me to ink, but this should be fun. This should be fun. I like doing this Lone Star costume.
Is that a new one?
No, it's the classic one.
Oh.
Remember the wings go up the sleeves? Yeah. Oh, it says Polis. Thank you, Polis.
I love that, dude. That looks so cool.
Right on. I'm going to send this over to the boys. The boys. And let's see. Save one as a JPEG. And then I will move that over to. Yeah.
Were you sending that to?
Doug, Matt, and Mike.
Oh, gotcha.
All right, and with that, ladies and gentlemen, inks will make it look better. Well, yeah, Vic, this is just a very tight breakdown, I would call it. I still have hours of penciling to do on this, probably, and then lots of inking. So next is that comic book. Next, Seicho's 55. I love the art style. 66. Oh no. Okay, let me. Do you guys want to see the other pages? I don't know if you've seen them, Elliot. Did you earlier? Screen one. What screen am I on? This screen. This screen. Sure. Oh, hang on. Let me take this off. So this is obviously the one I just sent them. This is page 5.
Oh wow.
Right.
Wow.
And guys, if you want to get on the mailing list for this, I'm just going to use the one mailing list this time for both Monster Hunt 2 and Lone Star. So just go to lonestarcomic.com and sign up at the mailing list there for goodies and stuff on the mailing list tier. Matthew Weldon, ladies and gentlemen, written by Mike Barron. Cool, right?
Yeah, that's cool. Good bike shot.
Yeah, dynamic.
And you saw the first three already, right?
I don't know for sure. I don't think so, no. Yeah.
Is Est Gormando in the background.
I saw this when he was working on it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Wow. Nice stuff.
So good. I love the dragon in the background. The thug is falling forward out of the panel. Thug. What?
Where's that?
Is that an aspersion?
Quit your aspersions.
Oh yeah, that's dope.
The goods. Definitely gonna be an exciting project. I hope everybody picks it up. And then some.
There's a lot of G2 ink on that.
Single-handedly keeping Bic in business.
It's true. I drew a G2 Batman today at the bank. Somebody said that it was their nephew's birthday, so I drew them a G2 Batman. Not nearly as good as Weldon's G2 stuff. But,
well, that's kind of you.
Yes, the Nexus, the old stuff, is still good today.
Was that a question?
It was a question from Vic.
Oh, Vic, master trolling.
Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are out of here. We're going to wrap it up with a lovely rendition of Finger Five. God bless you all, and have a good night. Oh,